Yeah, so Yah brings back all the herbs. He'll start germinating, and he'll bring it back. It'll be the Garden of Eden. Okay, it'll be that. You know, it got to get to that. And then, because we come back, we get rid of all the idols and images, and that's going to hasten even that much more. Yah's temple starts to be built. See, because again, when the brother, you know, he called, he like, "Yo, what's this 4820? And when I explained it, and then he like, "Oh, okay." He said, then he told me, he said, "You know, this person over there in the land, you understand, that went before Yah, right?" And he said, he's claiming, you understand, that's why him and whoever else, they left and went over to the land already, because of the coronavirus is here in America. And I said, "Yeah, but the coronavirus is over there in the land too." Okay? It's over there now. Been over there. I saw that here a few weeks back. They had, you know, Israel is one on the list. One of them is one of the nations that got the coronavirus. It's all over the earth. Okay? Because at that time when they showed it, it was 336 supposed infected people. They had cases of coronavirus. It's in the land too. So what you know, how can somebody say they ran out of, you know, talking about they fled out of the Babylon, door to Babylon, because, you know, that's why they left, because the coronavirus is here. It's everywhere. So that, you know, that don't hold any water. You understand what I'm saying? So, you know, hey, people come up with all kind of nonsense, right? Try to justify the things that they do. Okay, Chicago Tribune, March the 9th. Oil falls 25% as another week of virus fuel trading begins. Again, you know, Russia here about a month ago, three and a half weeks ago, Russia had been going along with Saudi Arabia, you know, keeping production, you know, at a certain level. And so they came out and said that Saudi Arabia had asked Russia to maintain that level of output, and Russia said, "No, we pumping." Okay? We pumping. And so now Saudi Arabia, that forced them, they have to let out so much oil too, because again, they're cash poor, the Saudis are. Okay? Because from what I hear, the bond market, you know, it is zilch. And again, when these collapses, economic collapse happen, people are running around trying to get liquidity. You follow me? Because again, everybody that's in, like I said, in paper, any kind of paper, that they're really deep in paper, they've got to try to now, they're going to have to come up with more and more and more paper, right? This is why these people like Joe Kennedy did, you know, I've talked about it in the past. I know some of you probably read about it and seen it. Before crashes, the people that get the inside, you know, knowledge, right, they sell short. I got an article coming up in the stash about these, you know, senators up on Capitol Hill sold short these stocks that they were invested in. You know, these stocks that they knew were going to get hit when this coronavirus was actually unleashed. They sold short and pulled their money down. See, and they talking about it's going to be an investigation. But again, one of the senators, this woman, her husband is he owns the New York Stock Exchange, one of the top heads. You know, in the New York Stock Exchange. So, you know, they get the inside information about these things. And so they sell short because they don't want to be caught in a situation where they got their money, you know, in the stock. The stock is worth so much. And then, you know, at a certain calamitous, volatile situation, then they know the stock is going to fall. And that means money is gone. So when they get, you know, forewarned about these things, they eat up going in and sell short and take their money. So they take it at the highest level before it starts to collapse, right? And that's these senators. You follow what I'm saying? They get that inside information. That's why they sold the stock. One of them's name is Burr. Like I say, I get to the article, right? I know many of you, if not all of you, heard about that. See, let you know that they were forewarned. That's why I just said about Trump. Like I said, he had a moment here the other week. He looked just like W did when the person came in and told W the trade centers had been hit. Right? He looked stupid because they already know that this stuff is going to happen before it happens. You see what I'm saying? They're getting the inside information. Okay? And that's why they make the moves that they make economically. See? I tell you, boy, it's something. You understand? Chicago Tribune, March the 11th. Virus upends Italy as cases top 10,000. Deaths hit 631. Okay? Chicago Tribune, March the 11th. Okay, what Trump doesn't care to know about COVID-19 could hurt us. Okay, he knew. He just couldn't let on that he knew. So he had to, you know, play it like he plays it, you know, oh, no, this ain't real and this and that. Then he had to turn around. Like I said, then he turned around at, you know, here a few weeks ago and said he knew it was a pandemic all the time. Now, that's a total about facing what he had been saying, right? So, like I said, so you mean to tell me you lost 2 to 3 vital months of preparedness? Now you putting people on a rush, you understand, for ventilators. You want Ford Motor Company to make ventilators, and you invoke this some law about production, and, you know, Ford got to make so many ventilators, right? Got Cuomo sitting up there, the governor in New York State, talking about we need 40,000 ventilators. It's a bunch of nonsense. I mean, like Gerald Celente says, and I didn't mention him before, you know, one of these economists who watches this thing, and he see, you know, this is all manipulated, perpetrated, right? And again, you have people who die of a virus every year. So many people die around the world of the viruses, right? But again, I have no doubt that they have upped the virulence of this particular virus. Like I say, that Dr. Michelle Berry, she said it's really SARS. You know, it's SARS. She said, but this is like SARS-2, where the other SARS here, you know, a few years ago was like SARS-1. So now, you understand, this is like, as some people say, you understand, SARS on steroids. And it's called the coronavirus. You follow me? SARS on steroids. So it's SARS-2. It's more virulent. And they've done it some kind of way. You understand what I'm saying? Like I say, in my mind, they doing it through the chemtrails, okay? That's part of it. You know, like I said to some people, you know, I said this to Yada, you know, a while back. But, you know, sometimes I say things to Yada and she poo-pooed me. You know what I mean? And that's okay. I mean, she got on, man. But, you know, this first Batman movie with Jack Nicholson, all right, Michael Keaton played Batman. For those of you out there that saw that, okay, what was, you know, Jack Nicholson played the Joker. And what did he do? He had chemicals that he was putting in different amenities and foodstuffs. And when you get a certain combination, you know, that people were using foods or amenities, deodorant, you know, hair oil, you know, soaps and whatnot, you get a certain combination or preponderance of this chemical that he was putting in stuff, they fall out and die. You get it? Now, for those of you who saw the Batman with Christian Bale, the first one, Batman Begins, what did they show you in that one? Huh? They had this chemical they were putting in the water supply, right? They was putting some kind of chemical in the water supply. And then they were vaporizing it. And when these vapors started to come out, right? People who, you know, was breathing in these vapors, they would like start hallucinating and they might fall out and die unless they were immunized. Now, again, I was watching something here I think it was on RT here the other week, and they were talking about vaccinations for this coronavirus. And in one of these vaccinations they was working on, they said it had rat, some kind of rat microbe or whatever from the rat, okay, in it. You follow what I'm saying? So now I saw another thing where they was like test kits that they were, people, they were saying test kits were all messed up because they had test kits telling people they didn't have the infection when they did. And then they had test kits telling people they had the infection when they did. You follow what I'm saying? See, this is what happens when you go to man. Now, you understand? Brother called me yesterday and we talking. He like, yo, he said, I know y'all all right, but I just called to see. I said, yeah, bro, we straight. He said, yeah. I said, how you and your family? He said, we good. Now, he works at the hospital down in Florida. Okay, fixing ventilators. You dig? He said, Yoda, it's a madhouse at this hospital where he is. He said, it's a madhouse. Okay, he said, man, it's crazy up in there. Now, I said, I know you fixed up, right? He said, oh, yeah. He said, I got mask on like a hazmat suit. You understand what I'm saying? So, I like, I hear you, bro. He said, yeah. He said, because he was on his way home, so he called me, so we talking, and we talked till he got home. He said, okay, you would have been there. Well, he said, I'm getting ready to go in, bro. I said, he said, I just called you. I said, okay, right on. He said, yeah, I got to go in here. He said, and go in the garage, take off everything. Take off everything before I go in the house, you know, with my family. I said, I hear you, bro. So, you understand? So, again, the hospital is the last place you want to go. Because that's where all the germs are going to be concentrated, as they always are. Plus the fact, you're running the man. You follow me? And he going to give you some kind of vaccine. It might not be the infection of the coronavirus that gets you. It might be the vaccine that gets you. Because they're about knocking people off. Again, the reign of power. I talked about it before. I watched it. Okay? When I watched this DVD I got from the barbershop years ago, and I watched it here the other week, because I watched that and I watched Loose Change. They talking about 9/11, breaking it down. You follow what I'm saying? And in this one that Webster Tarpley is in, okay, and talking, you understand? He mentions how, you understand? Because it was about eugenics, you know, like the King Albert plan. They want to get rid of people, right? And it was about eugenics. And Webster Tarpley said they want to get rid of about 6 billion people off the face of the earth, right? Because like I said, he mentions how, you know, they put forth, we got to get rid of these useless eaters. You follow me? See, so if the coronavirus don't get you, the vaccine might get you. I don't have any trust in any of what they come up with. Now, as I said here, I'm pretty sure I mentioned it last session. I'm pretty sure that's what I had, you know, as I touched on earlier, right? Back there at the beginning of February. Okay, because y'all had come in here coughing. And a few days later, I knew I was going to get, and then I came down. But as soon as I started feeling it, I went on the attack. Like I said, I took the ALO. I took like a teaspoon of ALO powder. You know, just pow in my mouth. Because Yada was mocking me. I was telling her what I was going to do. She said, I said, boy, I ain't looking forward to taking this ALO. She said, no, she mocked me. She said, no, you can deal with it. You the man. She said, you take that ALO, just put it right in on your mouth. Because she got capsules, and, you know, she because I tell you what, that ALO powder is a rough duck, okay? She said, no, she was mocking me. I said, yeah, I'm going to do it, okay? So later on, before I went to bed, like I said, I took a teaspoonful, a level teaspoonful of ALO powder, and I put it back in Matter of fact, what I did this time, I mixed it in with the prune juice. Okay? Matter of fact, no, I take that back. I mixed it in with water and just stirred it up. And then I put the prune juice on top of it and stirred that up, got the residue, because that stuff is something. It stick to your teeth, to your tongue. You know what I mean? And I wanted to get it all down. And I just about did that, right? And like I said, you know, I take the prune juice to knock the gas out. So the next morning when I got up, you know, I had fixed the tea, the enema tea that, you know, that night. I had a big, tall pot, you know, big pot. Got a big, huge stainless steel pot. And I fill it up with water, put the teas in there that I want to, you know, do the enema with, right? I had about four different, you know, teas I put in there. You understand? That's good for your stomach, good internally, you know, whatnot. And then I steeped it up and then turned the flame out and just leave the top on. And when I got up that next morning, the pot is still warm. You know what I'm saying? It's still warm because it's, you know, that stainless steel holds that heat, right? So I got up, made me a liver flush. You know what I mean? Two bulbs of garlic, you know, and cloves of garlic, right? Take off the bulb, take two cloves, cut it up in the glass, pour about ounce, you know, a lemon juice, maybe a little better than ounce and a half, you know, fresh lemon juice. Put the quarter teaspoon cayenne pepper in there, right? 2 tablespoons of virgin olive oil and 1 tablespoon of blackstrap molasses, right? And pour about 4 ounces of grapefruit juice and then another 4 ounces of orange juice. And stir it all up, drink that down, chew up that garlic, drink it down, right? That's the liver flush. And then wait about an hour and a half, and then start to give myself the enema, right? And I took an enema for 2 days, you know what I mean? Took it that Tuesday and that Wednesday, you follow me? And I'm feeling better. It had me, I was kind of coughing, not bad, right? And made me up a little, because at night, it really was only one night, I had kind of like a cough, and I made me up like a cough syrup. Use that grade B maple syrup, put a little in there, right? And squeeze me up a little real lemon, put some juice in there, right? And stir it up and had it sitting on the night table, you know, by my bed. And when I had a kind of cough, I just take a little drink of that and go on to sleep. You know what I'm saying? No problem. And I only needed it one night. Okay. Then, like I said, then that Thursday, I felt better, but it still was on me, but I felt better. Then that Friday, you know, I'm all right, right? But then that Friday night, like I said, brother called, and we was on the phone, because he called around 9, maybe 9:30, I had taken my bath, and so we were talking. Matter of fact, I took my bath when we was on the phone. We was talking. I had him on speakerphone. And then I got out the tub and got myself together, and, you know, I laid down, and we was talking, and I laid back because, you know, first I was kind of sitting up, and then I laid all the way back, and boy, I got all tight across my forehead, all into my nostrils, all across here. I mean, it was like pressure, tight. And I told him, I said, I can't breathe. He said, huh? I said, I can't breathe, man. Out of my nose, I couldn't breathe. It's all tight. And then I had to raise up. And then I tried it again, and it tightened up. And I said, man, I don't think I ever felt this. And then I raised up. So I went in the bathroom. I got the little Vicks Vapor Rub, put a little right here on the outside of my nose, and a little hit here and here, you know, at the opening of my nose. Not in my nose, but right at the opening. And then I could breathe all right. I said, okay, that's better. So we talked a little bit long, and then I said, okay, man, I'm going to call God. He said, yeah, go get you some rest. We'll talk. Because he kind of had something, too. And he out in Seattle. So, you know, got off the phone, but I slept okay. No problem. Got up the next day. But it took me about another, 5 days to actually come back, you know, to really get back, you know what I'm saying? And you know, not that I could really feel anything, but, you know, you kind of know when your body's not, like, you know, percolating like it's supposed to, you know, like it usually is, right? And then, because another brother that I had run into, you know, that Friday at the store, I told him, I said, yeah, man, I've been had a little bad. He said, yeah, I can see it in you. Then I ran into him again that following Friday at the store, and we was talking. We didn't talk long, and because I looked around once, he had disappeared. I guess he figured I got the virus, because he's a little bit older than me, right? And so then I saw him about 2 weeks later after that, and he said, hey, man, I said, last time I saw you, like, I looked around, you, like, disappeared. He said, yeah. He said, how you doing? I said, oh, I'm cool. He said, yeah, I can see. He said, last time I saw you, you didn't look like yourself. He said, I can see you all right now. I said, oh, really? He said, yeah. I said, okay. So, you know, but you know, you just attack it naturally. Blood purifies, cause, you know, Yada keeps this tea around here. She changes it, rotates it. And, you know, with the blood purifiers, she might have 5 or 6 different teas, you know, and she steeps it up and keeps it there, you know, and I basically, you know, I'm the one that drinks it. I think she drinks some sometimes, but, you know, I drink a cup, you know, maybe 4 or 5 times a week, you know what I'm saying, in the morning or when, if I have to leave, when I come back. So those are blood purifiers, you know what I'm saying? And she rotates them good. So, you know, after about 2 to 3 weeks, she'll rotate out and make up another batch, you know, or some different teas. And that keeps you from getting immune. You know, she might switch them out even sooner than that, okay? But that's what it's all about. You follow what I'm saying? And then you eating, you know, according to Yah's menu, right? You're not on this man's diet. Right? And so, but you know, Yah's got the herbs that we need. You follow what I'm saying? Like I said in the past, it's kind of hard to get some of these herbs now because Esau knows he's attacking us. He's been attacking us a long time, you know, removing things, you know, out of our reach, making it harder to attain whatever it is, you know, different things. But, you know, we've been blessed here to be able to get certain things because Yada tried to order some thing here the other day and she called them, they were out. And I said, yeah, because, you know, I've gone up in some of these stores, you know, health food stores and asked for, you know, different herbs or whatever, and they tell they out. I said, yeah, you know, you can see it, you know what I mean, wiped out. Because, you know, these people, they looking for the real cure, too. You know, they don't want to fool with any vaccine. I heard a Caucasian, you understand, European here a few weeks ago, about 3 weeks ago. I was in the store and he was at the counter, right? He was talking to, you know, the ladies working at the register. He was saying, this thing is something else. They said, yeah. And so they said, yeah, you know, you think you're coming down with something, you go get vaccine. He said, I'm not fooling with any vaccine. He said, I'm not fooling with any vaccines. He said, you know, I'll go and get some things. He said, but I don't want any vaccines. I said, I hear you. I said to myself, I hear you loud. Okay. Also, again, the Boy Scouts of America, decades of sexual abuse and an inevitable bankruptcy. Because, again, these Boy Scouts of America, you understand, these pedophiles were, you know, these scout leaders. They would get into the scouts where they, you know, weren't known and they started molesting these young boys, right? And that it was a preponderance of that. Now that's all coming out. What I just read over here, you know, in Yeshaya chapter 47, right? Yes, they can't hide anything anymore. Everything being brought out. See? Everything's being brought out. Okay? So, you know, you can't hide. I don't care who you are. You can't hide anymore. Because the Yah is on the scene and he's lifting himself up, as I've said in the past, and he's not going to allow anything and anybody to be hid. See, so like I said, it's really, you know, You understand what I mean? Now, like I said, they patented, huh, the coronavirus so that they come up, you know, the Peabody Corporation, right? The Gates Foundation, they patented the coronavirus. So if they come up with a vaccine, they can make all the money. You know what I mean? For the vaccine they come up with. I mean, you know, if you so much a humanitarian, why are you thinking about patenting any kind of virus, right? Vaccine. You know what I mean? Just bring the vaccine on out for the people. But you're talking about making money. So you're not, you understand? You're not coming from an altruistic standpoint. You're coming from a capitalistic standpoint. So how can you, you know, have any kind of trust in people like that, right? March 11th, Chicago Tribune. Fifth Third allegedly opened fake accounts to hit sales goals. Consumer Financial Protection Bureau suit says banks' employees move money without consent. Now, that's Fifth Third Bank. You follow me? They opened up fake accounts to hit sales goals. So that's like Wells Fargo did the same thing, right? See, because again, brother called here the other day and we was talking. He, how you doing? You all right? I said, yeah, you know, we cool. So we was talking and, you know, I know him. He's here in Chicago. And so we got to talking and I know he calling. He wanted to see, you know, what's going on. And I was telling him, and then he came around when I said, yeah, you know. We own some like a semi-martial law. And he said, yeah, you know. And then I said, because, you know, we could be just a step away from them shutting these banks down. He said, huh? He said, what? You? I said, you know. I said, you been to the bank lately? I said, you can't go in the lobby. They got the lobby shut down. It's only drive-through. And you can only take out $2,000 at once, you know, I guess in a day. That's it. He said, man, I better go take my money out the bank. I said, well, you know, you don't have to close the account down. Just leave enough in there so you can do business. I said, but, you know, they mess around here and shut these banks down and do a bail-in. You know, your money will be gone. He's like, oh, man, I'm going to the bank tomorrow. Okay, I'm telling you, you know, because they ain't gonna give you no heads up of what they're going to do before it happens. You know what I'm saying? But it's almost, you know, like almost kind of a martial law now, right? Because they got the National Guard in these different cities, right? Supposedly they help, you know what I mean? But at any time, if they want, they can turn that National Guard around, have them standing out there in these streets with, you know, with them AK, well, I don't know if they carry AK-47, but you know, with those automatic weapons, telling everybody, got to be in by 5 o'clock or 6 o'clock. You know what I'm saying? Chicago Tribune, March 11th. Okay. Saudis increase oil output to record high. Okay. Now, you hear that? Now, it says Saudi Arabia's state-run oil giant Saudi Aramco said Tuesday would increase its crude oil production to 12.3 million barrels a day, a record amount. That's supposed to start this month, April, right? Said the move seemed to make good on the country's promise over the weekend to increase output after Russia refused to cooperate on cutting production. That led to a 25% plunge in the price of crude on Monday, the sharpest decline seen since the 1991 Gulf War. All right? Said international benchmark Brent crude traded up more than 8% Tuesday over $37 a barrel. Now it's below 25. All right. Said in a filing to Riyadh's Tadawul stock market Tuesday, Aramco said the increase in production represented a rise of 300,000 barrels per day. Analysts said that likely would involve releasing stored barrels as well. Russia later responded by saying it too could increase output. Now you hear that? That's really what Saudi Arabia is letting out. Stored oil, not pumped. Because they don't have that kind of pumped oil in the ground anymore. You follow me? So they really letting out stored oil. You see? Stored oil. Because that's how bad they need liquidity. Like I said here last year around this time. I think it was around this time, right? Or before, when the Saudis had issued the IPO, the initial public offering, stock, selling stock. You only do that when you need liquidity, when you cash poor. Huh? They need cash. That's what happens in a depression, recession, depression, right? You need cash. People get caught, right? They have no cash on hand. Liquidity. Right? See? And that's what's going on with the Saudis. Okay? See? And again, another hit on why this is all, you understand, manipulation, this coronavirus. Because back in 1981, and Yadida told me, she had told me about this before, but I didn't remember, but I saw on that on the internet about this, you understand, Eyes of Darkness, this book that was put out by this person named Dean Koontz, K-O-O-T-Z, Dean Koontz, right, came out with this book in 1981, Eyes of Darkness, about this very same thing, pandemic, coronavirus, that's happening right now. See? Now. You follow what I'm saying? This is Esau's stuff. Okay? Manipulation. This is his attack. Huh? And trying to cover up, you know, economic collapse, which the fiat currency was destined to, you know, it was destined to happen to this fiat currency. Right? And a lot of people say it's long overdue because, yeah, some of these economists, they said they thought, yes, then this was going to happen. What's happening now? They thought, economically, they thought it was going to happen in 2008. But it didn't. See, this thing has gone on another 12 years. Now here it is. Economic collapse. They're trying to cover it up with this coronavirus nonsense. But this so-called book, Eyes of Darkness, huh? This scenario came out, you understand, a fiction book, supposedly, right? In 1981. But just letting you know, they had this up their sleeve back then. If we get to this place where we got to, you understand, you know, hit them, we're going to hit them with this bioweapon, this virus, right? Okay? And it was called, say about, they called it Coronavirus 400, weaponized in China. That's what the book, Eyes of Darkness, is about. Planting that seed that it started in China. You want to blame them because, you know, there's a lot of Asians been attacked around this country because of Trump and Pompeo, you understand? Trump's administration coming out talking about it's the China virus, the China virus. That's where it come from. And you had these idiots around here in this country attacking Asians and people who they perceive as Chinese who not even Chinese. Some of them, sometimes they from the Philippines. Okay? Because this article I read, I was telling y'all about it the other week. You understand? This Filipino person and another person that's not from China, the Asians though, they had gone to the show up on the north side of Chicago. All right? And when they left out the show, it's at night. You know what I mean? They was on their way home and all of a sudden they walk in, right? And they heard somebody say, you know, use the profanity, the F word, China, F China, right? And they looked around and this person came toward them and spit on the man. Spit on him. And they said, they didn't say nothing. They just kept on walking. Said the Asian guy wiped the spit off his jacket. And they went in and got on the L and, you know, went home. Okay? But that comes from Trump with his China virus nonsense. You know, they showed on Democracy Now! This Asian woman who was talking about how different Asians are being attacked around the country because of him saying this. See, you know, you understand what I mean? It's ridiculous, right? So, okay, because the book, as the darkness puts forth this scenario that the coronavirus was stolen, the shipment of it was stolen, that was destined for Canada, was stolen by China and taken on to China in the Wuhan province. And then it gets out, right, and starts infecting the people of the world. See, now that's some more Esau's, you know, preparing your mind to think a certain way, all the way back there in 1981. See, and again, 1981, you understand, about 11 years after, huh, Ben and me and them went over into the land, March 1970. You know, the last big bunch, you know, March 1970, right? About 11 years later, then they come up with this scenario. But 5 years before, yeah, righteousness popped up, but they knew it was coming. See? So again, you know, they got all of this stuff up the sleeve. You know what I'm saying? If this happened, we gonna do this. Like he told me in December 2010. We'll destroy the whole earth before we allow black men to sit on it, huh? Before we give up the dominion, right? You know what they think. Yes, then, y'all so tough, let him straighten it out. We're going to mess up everything we can. Let y'all straighten it out. You understand? He the most high, ain't he? You know, that's the kind of mindset. You know, like I said, nasty. You know, that's nasty. Like that Dr. Brown with Plimland when he's talking, yeah, them people who think that land of Israel or something, that land ain't nothing. It ain't nothing. It don't mean nothing. And that's how he was saying it. And I'm like, yeah, you hold that stance just like that. You keep that frame of mind, partner. Okay? Because, you know, they all in the JC. Okay? I had a little conversation with him some years back. You know, saw him up in the store. You know, approached him. He knew who I was, you know, but he was smiling, you know, touting his JC, right? It's Yeshua, it's Jesus, yeah, man. I'm like, okay, yeah, is that a man? I mean, it wasn't no long conversation. It was real brief because I saw he couldn't hear it. Now, hey, left him right alone. See. Chicago Sun-Times, March the 12th. 23 years for totally confused Weinstein. Y'all heard about him, I'm sure, right? Disgraced Hollywood producer makes rambling statement as he gets a near maximum sentence in landmark Me Too rape case. Got 23 years, and he got to go out to California for another trial. Okay? How are thy hidden things, secret things sought up and searched out, O Esau? Chicago Tribune, March the 12th. Trump bans travel from Europe. That was at first, right? As effects cascade in Chicago, St. Pat's Day parade canceled, okay? But check this out, because they canceled, you know, all parades here. Now, this is back in March 12th, right? But the United Kingdom not part of restrictions. That's for Trump's travel ban. You know, the United Kingdom wasn't part of the restrictions, right? And it was something else he said. It was the United Kingdom and what other country that weren't restricted, or was it? Matter of fact, it might have been just United Kingdom. And, you know, I saw somebody on RT, they like, well, that don't make no sense, because they was talking about it like the next day. They like, that don't make any sense, because you follow me, you could just fly. You in somewhere else in Europe, Western Europe, you just fly to Britain and then take a plane and go to America. So, you know, eventually he lifted that too. He made it a travel ban to the United Kingdom as well. All right. I tell you, boy. And it was another country, though, too. I'm trying to think, was it Italy? Because it was another country, too, beside the United Kingdom. And on Democracy Now, if I remember correctly, they said he had business concerns in the United Kingdom and this other country. So that's probably why he didn't put a ban on those two countries at first. But he came back and put a ban on them, too. Right? Tell you, boy. Chicago Tribune, March the 12th. Bloomberg's promises falling through. Campaign workers say they are getting pink slips by email. You know, because that Bloomberg, when he was running for president, he told the people who was working on his campaign that he would, you know, pay them no matter what, they would get paid out the full, the way it sounds like, until all this presidential stuff was over, right? But when he pulled out the race, he stopped paying them. So they upset, right? They got pink slips, right? But again, when you know, as they say, all politicians lie, right? All politicians lie. And all of these, you know, presidents and whatnot, they all lie. You follow what I'm saying? March the 12th, Chicago Tribune. The WHO declares virus a pandemic. Now, that's March the 12th. Okay? And that's when they declared it a pandemic. The World Health Organization. Chicago Sun-Times, March the 13th. Outbreak breaks markets. Wall Street suffers worst day since 1987. Okay? Look at him. He got his head in his hand. He all messed up. Okay? You follow me? You know? Because some say they see, you know, the Dow going down to 6,000. Okay? It's around, it started there around 21,000, but they say they see it going down to 6. All right? And again, they already been talking about all these people with these 401Ks, 457Bs, 403Bs, you know, these pension plans. They say they're going to be crying the blues when they get this printout, you know, I guess quarterly printout, right? Because they done lost like about, I think they said the average one done lost about 35% of its monies, you know, if not more, right? I think they said 35 to 80%. So, you know. Chicago Sun-Times, March the 13th. It might have been Ireland, the other country at first, that Trump said he was, you know, not putting the travel ban on, because they say he got concerns over in Ireland, and he had concerns in, you know, the United Kingdom, England, right, Britain. So he had to put it on them too, because he got this feedback, right? But U.S. strikes Iran-backed group that hit Iraq base. See, again, they claim, you know, they always want to bring Iran into it. But these are Iraqis that's hitting these bases over there, because they want America out. They want them to pull out all, you know, military bases out of their country. Okay? And I tell you, boy, Chicago Tribune, March the 13th. Big gatherings now banned. Okay? Big gatherings now banned. Okay? That was the headlines. March the 13th. Here in Chicago. Also it said Trump's market crashing coronavirus address shows we're in incompetent hands. Okay. All right. This alarm, you know. You say, I don't know about you guys, but I feel a lot better about the coronavirus pandemic after watching President Donald Trump's address to the nation Wednesday night. His compassionate and mistake-free speech made me realize our nation is in good hands, and we should not at all be terrified or think the person running our country has the intellect and empathy of a gas station plunger. This is a sarcastic, you know, column, okay, by this guy that writes for the Chicago Tribune. It's totally sarcastic, you know, and mocking, all right? But also, it says this is another article. Trump calls the coronavirus a foreign virus, exposing his flawed worldview. Okay? Said first it was the China virus, now it's the Europe virus, or maybe the EU virus. One thing's for sure, it's a foreign virus, not an American virus. At least that is how Donald Trump views the coronavirus, which the World Health Organization this week declared a pandemic. As of Thursday, it had spread to 116 countries, infected almost 130,000 people, and killed nearly 5,000. Okay, so, you know. Yeah, Trump and his administration totally exposed, right? Chicago Tribune, March the 13th, officials. U.S. strikes Iran-backed group that hit Iraq base. Okay? The U.S. launched airstrikes Thursday in Iraq, American officials said, targeting the Iranian-backed. They always gonna put Iranian, you know. Backed Shia militia members believed responsible for the rocket. You hear that? Believed. Right? Believed responsible for the rocket attack that killed and wounded American and British troops at a base north of Baghdad. Chicago Sun-Times, March the 14th. U.S. angry at China rumor. The State Department on Friday summoned China's ambassador to the U.S. to complain about recent comments from a Chinese foreign ministry spokesman suggesting that the U.S. Army may have introduced the coronavirus to Wuhan. The department said it had protested the comments from Deputy Ministry spokesman Zhao Lihan and noted that China's storyline about the COVID-19 virus has been shifting away from the Wuhan, Hunan market since mid-January, indicating that China is trying to avoid responsibility for the outbreak. But again, they could very well be correct, China, that it emanated from here. Like I said, they called the Spanish flu back in 1918 the Spanish flu, but it emanated out of Texas and or Kansas. Now, here in America, in other words. But they call it the Spanish flu, right? And here's an article out of March the 15th. It's somewhat of a comedic column called Shortcuts, okay? And it's called Digging Our Toes in the Sand. But it's pointing out how sand is, you know, a necessity to make different things like glass, right? How it's the main component, okay? But it's also beach sand, not desert sand, because you can't use desert sand to make glass, okay? And they're saying in this, you know, one of the things they're saying is the sparsity of beach sand, how it's becoming very, very rare, okay? So, you know, we've talked about that in the past. You know, how sand is essential because they say quartz is the most common component in the sand found in non-tropical areas. The sand is tropical coastal areas. The sand in tropical coastal areas is made mostly of calcium carbonate that comes from the shells and skeletons of reef organisms. And now we know many of these reefs, coral reefs and whatnot, are being destroyed, you know, by all of the contamination, acidity in the oceans, right, in the waters. Rivers, lakes, you know, oceans, whatnot, seas. So you know, because again, they're using sand to make all the glass. Like I say, I'm looking at this, you know, this internet, you know, this computer is glass, you know, that I'm looking at, right? And all these phones, glass, right? And you're seeing a sparsity of sand that can be used to make glass. You know, TVs, computers, phones, car windows, right? Truck windows, airplane windows, so on and so forth. And they're using all this petrochemical to make plastics of all different kinds, which again are contaminating the earth. It's become a biohazard, you know, fossil fuel hazard. And again, to get more of a handle on that, watch Plastic Wars on that PBS I mentioned earlier. Chicago Sun-Times, March the 15th. Okay. Says Spain put on lockdown, France shuts landmarks. So they're not making any money. People going to look at the landmarks, Eiffel Tower and so on in France, right? Americans brace for life with no school and growing dread. Okay. And then his article said, color me healthy. Vegetables, fruits are a must for smart eating. Okay? And a must. See? And you got all these people in the world eating all this, you know, because again, China's one of the biggest consumers of pig, pork. They're the biggest consumer of pork on earth. They eat pork all kind of ways. And I saw, you know, documentary on that a few months back. You know, maybe last year, I saw this documentary. Man, them Chinese eat pork all kind of ways. They biggest consumer of pork, right? But again, you really have to be a big consumer of pork to out-pork America, because look at all these people that eat pork here, huh, in this country, right? Like I said, that Dr. Warren, he, that's a lie. Ain't no coronavirus coming through the pig. Okay. You understand? He don't want to believe that. You follow what I'm saying? You know, because he eat pig. You know, because JC told him it's okay. Everything good. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, that brother got real, his spirit got real dampened when I mentioned that chicken turkey. He like, what? You, huh? You know, I ain't heard from him since. But that's not to say he might, you know, might not call again, you know. Chicago, Sun-Tan, March the 15th. Virus ends bull market. Hear that? It was the longest in history, stretching from March the 9th, 2009 to February 19th, 2020. And again, that's the bubble. All right? That's the bubble that happened after the 2008 subprime crash, right? You know, they was just printing paper. That's why the paper worthless now. It's, you understand? People trying to get out of all forms of paper and get down there into that silver and gold, but everybody can't get down there. So that's why I say earlier, they didn't tell me, both ends of the country, and we've heard it, you know, like I said, that Kid Cole and some other people on the internet, they say you can't get gold, silver right now. You definitely can't get any silver. And I don't think you can really get gold right now, but you definitely can't get any silver. They said, you know, the market's kind of closed up right now. And my thing is, why would, like I said to all of you in the past, when this thing really hits, why would these silver and gold places sell silver and gold for worthless green dollars? Because if they don't see where they can get the green dollar, sell you know, they're going to make a profit, you know, on the markup over spot. And they say a lot of these people selling silver, the spot market over spot was marked up big time, $6 to $8. And that's a big markup on silver, okay? Because generally silver markup might be anywhere from $1.75 to, you know, maybe right at $3, all depending on what, you know, mint you get. But $6 to $8, that's a big markup on silver over spot. You know, gold is anywhere from $30 to $40, okay, over spot. But if they don't see where they can sell it and then lay that paper off somewhere and you know, buy the product again, you understand what I'm saying? And you know, where they can really make money, they're gonna shut down. Whether they got, they can have 5 tons of silver and gold back there. But if they can't see where they're making any money, they're not gonna keep taking that fiat currency for the real money. Think about it. What would you? Huh? So they'll say they don't have it. Like I said, they might have five tons back there in the back. But they're gonna tell you, we out, we don't have it. You understand what I'm saying? Chicago Tribune, March the 16th. Sudan will mediate Egypt-Ethiopia dam dispute. Didn't I tell you water's at a premium? Okay? Water drying up. Yah's drying the water up like he said he was going to do. Yeshua chapter 42. Huh? And I think it might be one or two other places. A top Sudanese general on Sunday said his country would mediate a deal on a dispute between Ethiopia and Egypt over Ethiopia's controversial dam on the Nile River. Okay? Tell you, boy, huh? They say tensions are rising in East Africa because of the impasse between Ethiopia and Egypt over the $4.6 billion Grand Ethiopian Renaissance Dam. It's 71% complete and promises to provide much needed electricity to Ethiopia's 100 million people. Egypt fears the project, set to be Africa's largest hydraulic dam, could reduce its share of the Nile, the main source of fresh water for Egypt's population of more than 100 million. Okay, water's at a premium. Right. Also in Spain, Spain's royal house said Sunday that King Philip VI has renounced any future personal inheritance he could receive from his father, King Emerite Juan Carlos I, over the alleged financial irregularities involving the former monarch. Philippe is also stripping Juan Carlos of his annual stipend. Don't worry, Juan Carlos probably done stole so much, he don't need it. You understand what I'm saying, right? Because people, you understand, the mass is rising up because they don't have any money. And they're like, yeah, look at them, where they live, you know, they stealing. So the son, he's sitting on the throne, like, okay, well, I'm going to, you understand, I'm not going to take any future personal inheritance that, you know, comes from my father. You know, because he done bled y'all dry. You follow what I'm saying? The decision comes amid an investigation by Swiss prosecutors into an offshore account allegedly operated for Juan Carlos. The account allegedly received $100 million from Saudi Arabia's late King Abdullah in 2008, which prosecutors believe could be kickback payments. Philippe was reportedly named as a beneficiary of a fund that controls the account. He has denied any knowledge of the fund. I know he did. See? But this is the kind, this is what happens when you get economic collapse, and this is worldwide economic collapse per se. Now, again, you know, China, Russia, they're all right. You know, I heard, you understand, somebody said China broke. China not broke. Okay, China all right. They got debt. You follow what I'm saying? But it's not any kind of debt like America, nowhere near it. And it's not any kind of debt that China can't handle. Okay? They not broke by any stretch of the imagination. How could you be broke and you got anywhere from 20 to 30 tons of gold? Okay? You understand? Like I said, if they got that much gold, which people, some people have said they figure they got over 20 tons. If they got that much gold, you know they got so much silver. Okay? But America is broke. Dead broke. You understand? That's why they confiscated $30 billion of Iraqi oil money. You understand? I talked about that last session before that. You understand? That's what, you understand, Trump had told that president, You understand that Totem said, I'm not doing that. I'm not signing, you know, half our oil revenue over to you. So, you know, Trump said, that's the only way we'll rebuild your infrastructure. Okay? And then, it led up to Soleimani and that Iraqi general and three others getting killed by the American drone. Because, again, Saudi Arabia, they looking for some help. They looking for a way out of this debt that they've got, right? And that's why, again, they coming out with stored oil, not pumped, stored oil, all right? And selling it for this cheap price because the world is awash in oil right now, huh? Now, Russia, they're not in any financial trouble. They could have pulled back like they had before, but they refused to do it. You follow me? They going to keep on pumping at the rate they've been pumping. And again, this is putting all of these oil drillers here in America out of business. They going bankrupt. Because here about 3 weeks ago, I heard they was up in D.C., up there at the White House, raising cane with Trump. Say, you got to do something, okay? Because they going bankrupt. A lot of them is already bankrupt. These oil producers here. See, because they can't make any money at $25, $21 a barrel oil. Anything below like $60 is destruction for these oil producers over here. You know, they already was behind the eight ball, these frackers, because it cost them $1.50 for every dollar oil they was getting out from fracking. So you're already behind the eight ball right there, right? But now when the Saudis started putting out, you know, this oil and the Russians putting out this amount of oil, and then it pushes the price down, right, to where it is now. I know all of you seen it at the pump, wherever you go, right? And I got gas for $1.75 here the other day, a gallon. I haven't seen those prices, and I don't know when. You follow me? See, so all of these oil producers here, they got to get at least $60 a barrel. And now it's down to like, I think $21, $22 a barrel. You understand what I'm saying? They gone bankrupt, going into bankruptcy. And a bunch of jobs that, you know, they had going, these people are out of jobs. So you understand what I'm saying? Trump can't do anything about it, right? Chicago Tribune, March the 16th, virus brings daily life around the world to a halt. Places of worship, cafes, bars closed in bid to slow spread. Okay, so the houses of idol worship, they closed down. I saw in the paper the other day, I think I pulled it, but if I didn't, I'm going to tell you now, Caucasian preacher opened up a church, where was that, in Houston, I think it was. He opened up the church and people came and they arrested him. They say, man, you got to close down. They arrested him, okay? Because, you know, they probably told him, hey, man, you understand? You know, Jesus can't protect you now against this corona, this coronavirus, right? Huh? You know what I'm saying? But they got all their faith in JC, right? Right? So, also amid exceptional year, Saudi Aramco reports 20% drop in profits. Told you, Saudi's in deep trouble economically. They own a lot of assets, but they cash poor. Because like I said, they selling the oil to China. They getting the RMB, the yuan. Okay? They not getting any dollars. I know the Saudis probably got plenty dollars, like China. Huh? Plenty dollars. But the only place you can dump them dollars is here. Nobody else want them. That's why this Illuminati boys of the West is doing what he's doing. Huh? All these central banks coordinated, Western Europe, here in America, right? Yeah, that's why he's doing what he's doing. See? Because these, you got a bunch of countries, hey, don't bring me that funny paper. I'm not taking that. Because I can't do anything with that. See? So that's why I say this is it. This is the big one. Okay? This is the big one, all right? Okay, amid an exceptional year. So they had an exceptional year, but they lost 20%. They down 20%, in profits. Say, oil giant Saudi Aramco said Sunday that its profits dropped 20% in 2019 to $88.2 billion. Now, when I say that, I know many of you out there gonna like, oh man, they got plenty of money. $88.2 billion. Yeah, but see, when you got Godzilla on your back, you can't feed them cheetah bananas. Okay? Godzilla eat a whole lot more bananas than cheetah. You follow me? So that they made $88.2 billion, but they might be spending, they might be spending $4-5 billion a day. That's what they need to feed Godzilla. They might need $4-5, $6-7 billion a day. You understand? I'm just, you know, hypothetical, right? It could be $10 billion a day because they own a lot of stuff. Like I said, they got Godzilla on their back. You follow me? And if you understand, Godzilla hungry and he's sitting up on your back, he looking down at you, isn't it feed time? And you say, here, you give him bananas to feed, you know, a few bananas that could only feed cheetah, huh? And Godzilla sucked them up in a second. He's still looking at you. Hey, I'm hungry. And in a minute, if you don't give me something, I'm going to eat you. And that's what happens when you got all these assets, these things that you have to, you carrying, that's got to be fed economically every day. You follow me? See? Because you can believe Saudi wouldn't be selling this oil at this cheap price. You understand what I mean? If they didn't have to. That's why I said, you know, last year when they did the IPO, you only do that when you need liquidity, when you need cash, you cash poor. And this always happens in depressions. You know, like I said to some, all of you out there have seen any of those old documentaries about the Great Depression back then, 29, 30, 30, 31, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right? You go back there and look. And you remember seeing, yesterday, they had the camera coming down the street, right? And you see these, you know, you see different cars, you know, maybe 2-3 old cars, maybe late model cars, Model T's or whatever, you know what I mean? Maybe some roasters back then, right? And they sitting out there. And you look up in the window of the car, and first they had $900, but it's crossed out. Then they had $750, it's crossed out. Then they had $600, it's crossed out. Then they had $450, it's crossed out. Then, you understand? You might have saw $300, and then right when the camera got there, you see the person crossing out the 300 and putting 250 or 170. Give me, I need some money now. You follow what I'm saying? That's what's going on with the Saudi. That's what's going on with a lot of people right now. They cash poor. Okay? They got to pay their rent. They got to pay the gas bill, the light bill, the water bill. If they don't pay those bills, right, they might can go a month or two. The gas bill, you know, the gas company might let them go a couple of months. The electric company might let them go a couple of months. But they, you know, insofar as not turning it off. But that bill is still there and is accruing late charges, right? But when you start getting around that third month, you ain't paid that gas bill, they're going to come turn that gas off. You ain't paid that light bill, they're going to turn them lights off, that electric off. Okay? Now, I just read your article about, you know, matter of fact, I didn't read the article. I mentioned it, you understand, in that one of those Democracy Now. They're cutting the water in Detroit for the people. Okay? And if you watch that Democracy Now the other morning I mentioned, you're going to hear this doctor running it down. Okay? He's talking about how, you understand, it was white flight. That's what he called it. He's an epidemiologist. And he was on that Democracy Now! Show here the other morning. He said it was white flight. The Caucasians fled Detroit. And quite naturally, the few people that was there of color, basically Israelites, right? And even if they Palestinians, they Israelites, right? Because that's where Rashida Tlaib comes from. You know, one of them other squad, right? Up there on Capitol Hill in the House of Representatives, right? So he said, and then it left this huge water bill for the few people who were there of color. You follow what I'm saying? They want them to pay these bills, and they can't pay it, so they turn the water off. See? Now, how are you humanitarian, huh? And they're talking about with this coronavirus to wash your hands, right? Regularly, right? But they turning people's water off. Like I said, you'll see that Democracy Now, you pull it up, right? Okay, so virus brings daily life around the world to a halt, okay? And the Saudis, they lost, you understand, they down 20% from what they made last year, okay? Chicago Tribune, March 17th. China's spin on outbreak. U.S. might have started it. That's what they say is China's spin. Okay, they call it a conspiracy theory as to downward spiral in relation. But China could, I look at it, they dead on. That's how I look at it. It was started here. That's these people here trying to cover up, trying to slow China and Russia down and cover up their, you understand, their economic collapse. You follow me? That's you know, their answer. That's the magician's trick. Okay? Also, the Edomites, the Israelis, staggers swearing in of its new parliament. Okay? Because they finally reached a deal here a few days ago. They're going to have a shared administration. Netanyahu going to do the first like year and a half, and Benny Gantz going to do the last year and a half. Because neither one of them can come up with a majority. So, as of right now, they've settled on that. Okay? But Netanyahu fighting for time because he got these indictments on him. He's supposed to go to trial. Okay? You reap what you sow. Divisiveness. Huh? And just like we see with the Edomites, right? Divisiveness. It got to be going on, you know, with the Edomites over in the land. Got to be going on with the Illuminati Edomite. That's how I see it, okay? They drinking of the cup of drunkenness. Now, it's out of the hands of Jerusalem. We'll never drink it again, right? Yeshaya chapter 51, March 17th, Chicago Tribune. Dow dives 2,997 points amid fears of recession. Well, they don't have to fear it because, you know, Goldman Sachs and some others, they didn't come out and say we in a recession, and it really is a depression. Because, you know, they say index records worst one-day loss since Black Monday in 87, and I remember that. Okay? And again, this is what you see here. You see this brother here? He getting the last thing of toilet paper. That looked like toilet paper or paper towel. He getting the last one off the shelf. Look how empty those shelves are. And that's just what you see. Okay? No toilet paper, no paper towel. That's toilet paper he getting. He's getting the last one. Okay? Shortage of toilet paper. No. The household staple is a product that is typically made to order. Okay? So, again, like I said, I ended up finding, but a lot of these places you go, they don't have any paper towel and no toilet paper. None. Nada. Okay? And maybe they got some today. And that was Monday when I went around. Okay? China. Virus took toll on economy. China's consumer spending and factory activity fell more than expected in January and February as it fought a virus outbreak, prompting some forecasters to warn this year's economic growth might slump to its lowest level since the 1970s. Retail sales fell 20.5% from a year ago after shopping malls and other businesses were closed in late January. Okay, factory output declined by a record 13.5%. after the Lunar New Year holiday was extended to keep manufacturing employees at home. The unexpectedly bleak figures suggest the world's second largest economy is shrinking despite the ruling Communist Party's efforts to revive manufacturing and other industries, some forecasters said. Again, this is, yeah, they're going to take a hit, but they far from being broke. They all right. I didn't heard, you know, different economists talk about that, like Dr. Richard Wolff, okay? He like, you know, China's going to be hit, but they're not going to be hit nowhere near like America, okay? France hits Apple with $1.2 billion fine. French regulators fined Apple $1.2 billion on Monday for striking deals to keep prices high and the biggest ever such sanction by France's competition authority. Okay? You hear that? $1.2 billion fine. Okay? On Apple. Chicago Sun-Times, March the 18th. Spain cases spike. One new case in Wuhan. Okay, they say some bright spots emerged. Wuhan, the central Chinese city where the virus was first detected late last year, reported just one new case Tuesday. And again, you know, why would China, if they let it out, why would they let it out on themselves? Huh? Supposed to be an accident? It accidentally got out, right? But they had a conference on it here, huh? A simulation of the pandemic back in October last year, right? And then this Dean Koontz wrote Eyes of Darkness back and put that out back in 1981. The same scenario that they telling us over here that happened in Wuhan, China in December of last year. Huh? Think about it. Chicago Sun-Times, March the 18th, $1 trillion bailout justified, but put working people first. See, this is when they was talking about it. And so this is opinion, editorial in the Chicago Sun-Times. They said, but put working people first. So they giving working people, what, $1,200? If you make less than, what is it, $75,000 a year, you're getting $1,200 check in the mail at some point. Okay, haven't gotten it yet. I think it's about another couple of weeks before you actually can get it, I think, right? $1,200, you know, whoopee, right? Whoopee, yeah, oh man. What did Trump say? It's huge, it's going to be big. Oh, $1,200, right? Yeah, but these corporations is getting billions of dollars, like Boeing. They supposed to be getting like 50 billion, huh? After they killed up, what, 300-something people? You understand, with that 737 MAX, with that, you know, that farce of, computer equipment they put in there, all messed up, you know, the pilots ill-trained, killed up 300-something people in two crashes, you follow me? Because the pilots was, you know, not properly trained, and the equipment they put in there was faulty. You follow me? At best. Okay? Yeah, man. You know, Boeing's, you understand, stock went down. They hollowed out the company. They get the loans from the bank like these other corporations. Instead of putting it into the company, they buy back their own stock, which used to be illegal. Companies, corporations couldn't buy their own stock until when Reagan was in 1982, he instituted the law. He changed that. It changed under Reagan. You know, I say he, but you know, he wasn't doing nothing. He just figured it, right? But you understand, the powers that be, they changed that law. Corporations could start buying their own stock. So, you know, like I said, they planning all this stuff. Now, that law came in 82. Dean Koontz wrote Eyes of Darkness in 81. Now, like I said, they got the chessboard, huh? They all up in front of this thing because they know from what they've done years earlier, this is eventually, huh, going to bring this about. So they start making scenarios to handle this outbreak, this collapse, when it happens, when it gets to the point where, you know, they can't manipulate it anymore, huh? They can't kick the can down the road anymore. All right, well, when that happens, then we'll put a pandemic on them and say this is, you understand, economic collapse is cause of that. People out of work because of the coronavirus, because we don't want it to spread. You follow? Chicago Tribune, March the 18th. Enroll reversal, Asia seeks to halt virus from returning. Border controls expanded as number of new cases drops. Okay. Reeling movie theaters closing nationwide. Okay. People out of work. Huh? People out of work. Locked down in their dwellings. whatever their dwellings are, houses, apartments, whatever. They lock down and they dwell. They told only come out to go get food, necessity, and go right back home. If you got a job, go work it. If they let you work, come on home. Huh? Sound like martial law to you? Semi-martial law. Chicago Tribune, March the 18th. China to expel U.S. reporters after curbs put on its media. So they put curbs on the Chinese media here. And so China said, okay, y'all got to leave out of U.S. reporters got to leave out of here. Okay? Because China's like saying, you think we're going to allow you to, you understand, blame this on us? Huh? And we know it didn't emanate from us. More than likely, you the one that put it out. See? And you don't want our reporters over there saying the truth. You Muslim our reporters, we putting yours out there. Okay, rockets strike Baghdad's green zone. At least three rockets struck Baghdad's fortified green zone near the American embassy late Tuesday, a day after the attack on a training base south of Baghdad, where U.S.-led coalition troops and NATO trainers were present, Iraqi security officials said. Huh? It was the fourth such attack in the span of a week. Okay? I tell you, the Iraqis want all the American bases out. They want America out of their country. Now. Huh? ASAP. March the 19th, Chicago Tribune. Closed borders within Europe unleash chaos. Congestion reigns. Goods stranded amid outbreak. Because here the other day on RT, yesterday we saw Yada had it on the screen. I'm like, man, where is that? And it was people lined up here. And it was here on the expressway. As far as you can see, cars was lined up. For trying to get, go to the food pantry to get some food. On the expressway. I mean, it was a traffic jam. It was like, looked like it was 2-3 miles long. I'm like, my goodness. Okay. I forgot exactly where it was. Okay. What state. But this thing's a mess. Okay. Kind of reminds me, when I think about it, those documentaries, those old films of the Depression, right? And you used to see people lined up and maybe 7, 8, 9 across. And they'd be lined up, maybe 2-3 blocks waiting to get a bowl of soup and some bread. All right? See? And again, they know, too, with this pandemic, supposedly coronavirus, right? You understand? If this economic collapse had taken place and you didn't have the so-called virus out, right? People might be storming the White House right now. Huh? Storming Capitol Hill right now. You follow me? Like they did back there in the 30s at the Depression. And I talked about this way back. I saw pictures of it on this old documentary. They had, the people was had set up shanties and tents on the White House lawn. I mean, they was everywhere. Some of you might have seen that. That's back then in the 30s, the Depression. And it was all over the White House lawn, out in front of the White House. And they had been out there so long, I forget how long they were out there, that the powers that be sent Eisenhower and Patton, old George Patton, the general, the warmonger, they had them send tanks out there, them little old bitty, and sent tanks out there to disperse them. So they don't want that. You understand what I'm saying? So they like, hey, the coronavirus, you don't want to get contracted coronavirus, see? So stay in so that you don't get coronavirus. You got people out here wearing masks. I went out and cut the lawn this morning. All right? And people come in, they got masks on. You understand? And they didn't come out just here the other day and said, these masks ain't doing nobody no good. You understand what I mean? And you don't need no masks. The masks might be, hurting you more than helping you. Huh? See, because whatever you got in you, you already got it in you. Now, okay? Now, you understand what I'm saying? You know, I'm telling you, you know, people, you know, because again, whatever they tell you, just think about it in the reverse, right? Again, Yeshaya 24, they didn't turn everything upside down. They call the bitter sweet and the sweet bitter, dog light, light dog, wrong, right, wrong, right? So whatever they tell you, just think about it in the reverse. So if they tell you should wear a mask, you probably shouldn't. I don't wear one. I'm going out. I don't have no mask on. I see other people with masks. You know? Now, I don't want anybody coughing on me. Okay? You follow what I'm saying? But, you know, I'm not wearing a mask. Like I said, I just went out this morning and was out there cutting the lawn. And I saw 2, 3, 4 people with masks on. Okay, Chicago Tribune, March 19th. Quake rattles Utah residents already on edge from virus. They had an earthquake in Utah. Huh? Got a lot of them Mormons over there, Quakers or whatnot in Utah, don't you? Chicago Tribune, March 19th. Ford, GM to close all North American auto plants. Okay? A lot of people out of work. Volatility persists. S&P falls 5.2% as Dow sheds 6.3%. Investors dash for cash amid fears of recession. You hear that? Dash for cash amid fears of recession. Okay? See? Because again, when you cash in all of that paper, huh? You follow what I'm saying? The stocks and the bonds and the mutual funds and the pension plan, you trying to cash all that in? What are they going to give you? They ain't going to give you gold or silver. When you go in to cash in those paper gold, paper silver certificates, huh? ETFs or whatever, you understand? When you cash that in, what they going to give you? They don't give you gold and silver. They give you green paper. Huh? They give you dollars. Then you have to take those dollars and try to run, huh? And get you something of worth. Right? You follow me? See? And again, they manipulate the silver and the gold down here in America. Because I hear, you know, we've been hearing the gold is like $1,900, close to $2,000. Or 2,000 euros or real, you know, RMBs or something in other countries. But here they manipulate it down because they don't want it. You know what I mean? And they can't keep the gold because the gold, they push it down, they pop right back up. Huh? You know, that's because it's busting. You follow what I'm saying? But they don't want people to be enamored with the gold and silver. But yet and still, huh? They got the silver down, really depressed, right? And the people is what? You understand? They trying to cash in, get the dollars and run and get silver. But when they get to the door, we close. We out. No silver. No gold. You follow me? Chicago Tribune, March the 20th. Schools closed till April. All right, well, this is April 1st, and they still going to be closed. And more likely than not, they're going to be closed the whole month of April. Okay? The whole month of April, more than likely, these schools here in Chicago are going to be closed and around the country. Chicago Tribune. Huh? March the 20th. China bounces back to help others. You hear that? China helping other nations as of March 20th. And then, you know, I think I got in here. They had another breakout. They said another flare up here the other week. So now where that coming from? You going to tell me that's coming from Wuhan too? You follow me? Also, coronavirus sparked surge of gouging complaints in U.S., right? Because, you know, these people, like I say, they gouging. They know that they know people need these certain things, so they jacking the price up. Hand sanitizers, right? You understand? Lysol spray, Lysol in the bottle. You understand what I mean? You know, different things of that nature. Bleach. You know what I mean? A woman on Democracy Now this morning, she talking about she had a baby, and she talking about, you know, she's afraid. When they first brought her on, she was crying. When they showed the little clip, she was crying and everything. Then, you know, later on, when they actually brought the interview on with her and Amy Goodman, right? And she was talking and whatnot. And check what she said. She said, me and my husband, you know, just had the baby. And we want to keep to protect our child. And so, you know, we go out, we come back. And you know, when we was hearing all this, we jumped in the shower. You understand? We jumped in the shower, me, my husband, and the dog. Did you hear me? She said, me, my husband, and the dog. We put the dog in there and washed the dog, too. I just shook my head, huh? They can't see, right? Dog got fleas, got tick, got lice. And you got it all in the house. Whew. Okay. Also, coronavirus sparks surge of gouging complaints in U.S. They jacking the price up. They know people need things. Hey, you got to pay more. There's more here. If you want it, I don't care. Get out of the way. Let this people go. They going to buy it. Because they already done said that Amazon, Costco, Walmart, huh? These three big retailers, they have made all the money they made last year. They've already made it this year. 3 months. They've already made as much money so far this year that they made all last year. Okay? Because people going buying and stocking up. Right? Also, Trump seeks $3 billion to shore up nation's petroleum reserves. Okay? I told you, about 3 weeks ago, they was all up on Capitol Hill, you know, not Capitol, but at the White House, raising cane with Trump. You got to do something, man! Okay? So he wants $3 billion to help the shale producers out. But see, this can't keep going on, right? If things don't change, you got to let them drop. Same thing with Saudi Arabia. Right? They pushing out the oil to store it all now, but they can't keep doing that. That only lasts for so long. And then they got it, you know, they don't want to exhaust all their reserves. And again, that's basically what Saudi, they're not pumping any oil, but they don't have it like that. We didn't talk about that, right? They all been running dry since 2010. And then here about, 3 years ago, I said that guy Stephen Hickey said the Saudis don't have any oil. He said about the oil that they have, you understand, it's like flour in a sack. You got to shake it, and you get a little flour. He said, that's about the way they oil is in the ground now, which means on order kind of like fracking. So they talking about they pushing out stored oil. That's how bad they need cash, because they cash poor. Like I just read to you, people coming out of the stocks, right, out of the paper trying to get cash. See, and that's what's making the dollar look like it's strong, but it's really not. That's what you get paid when you come out of that white paper, beige paper. You understand what I'm saying? They give you green paper. Now, this is all we can get you. It's people that want gold and they supposed to have gold and silver. We ain't got that. We give you this paper. Then you got to take that green paper and run and try to get you some gold and silver. But like I say, they get into the gold and silver shop and it's got a sign up there, we close. Or you go in and say, I want to buy silver. I want to buy gold. We out. Like I said, they might have 5 tons sitting back there in the back. You understand what I mean? But they're not taking that worthless green paper. We out. Now, you come back next week, maybe, you know, a couple of weeks, maybe we have something. You understand? Okay, U.S.-led coalition troops exit Iraqi base despite more attacks. Hear that? Iraqis starting to rise up, boy. They raising cane, huh? Israelis protest power grab by Netanyahu amid pandemic. The Edomites was over there fighting one another the other week, right? Because they say Netanyahu trying to power grab. You understand? A mid pandemic, he said, you know, I got to stay in office to fight the coronavirus. Okay? I tell you, boy, pulling the covers, huh? It's pulling the covers off of everything, huh? And again, what did y'all say in 47 Yeshaya? They shall not know from where it rises, where it's coming from, because I'm going to bring it from everywhere, right? Chicago Tribune, March the 20th. Illinois unemployment claims skyrocket. Outbreak causes businesses across the state to shut down. Hear that? Huh? Workers are overwhelmed because there's a huge increase in applications over the last 2 weeks, and it's growing daily. And again, unemployment was already high. You know, you didn't believe that 3%, 2% nonsense, right? It was already high. Now it's much higher. You know, they was talking this morning, was it yesterday? I listened to something, they say, you know, unemployment might go as high as 30, 30, 35, 32% or something like that. And I said, if they saying that, it might go to 60. Okay? Chicago Tribune, March the 20th. U.S. jobless claims jumped by 70,000. Amid layoffs. Cautious optimism caps mixed day on Wall Street. Okay? You know, because they do a little up, you know. They raise it up a little bit, and then next day it falls even more. You know, they let it go 2-3 days, and then they drop it back down because it's going down. All them stocks is going down. Bank of England cuts rate to 0.1%. That's the interest rate. Huh? The Bank of England slashed its main interest rate to 0.1%, the lowest level since its founding in 1694, and reactivated a bond-buying stimulus program to cushion against the economic shock of the coronavirus pandemic. Huh? The bank's 9-member monetary policy committee said Thursday that the moves were designed to meet the needs of UK businesses and households in dealing with the associated economic disruption. The interest rate cut comes just about a week after the central bank cut its rate from 0.75% to 0.25% at another emergency meeting. Many economists think the outbreak will cause an economic slump of a depth unseen since the 1930s. Okay, now this is what I mentioned earlier, that when you look at that Max Kaiser on the 24th, right, of March, he had Alex Dale McLeod on. Now check this out. The Fed, right, 9 central banks start currency swap plan. The Federal Reserve has set up a program to exchange dollars for foreign currency with 9 central banks to support dollar lending in world markets that are under pressure from the effect of the viral outbreak. That's the spin, right? That's the magician trick, right? The move announced Thursday enables foreign banks to provide dollars to their banks that sometimes lend and trade in U.S. currency. It is the latest effort by the Fed, that's the Federal Reserve, right? The private corporation that runs the monetary system here in this country and in these other, many of these other countries. Like I say, these 9 countries, right, where they got central banks set up, European central banks, right? And again, when I say that, think about what it say over there in Jeremiah chapter 50. I forget the verse. Wait a minute. I'll read it to you, what I'm talking about. Because when they set this Federal Reserve up, okay, they got it legalized in 1950. And it got up and running, you understand, like 1916, I think it was. But it really, you know, they really started taking over in 1933, okay, when they put all the banks out of business, when they had the bank, you understand, shut down, bank holiday, right? And when they opened back up, the Federal Reserve was in total control of all finances here in America. And again, what does it say over here in chapter 50, Jeremiah? Okay, again, I'm going to pick this up at verse 35. And this is from Yahweh's. Okay, and let me go back to 34. Matter of fact, let me start at 33. Thus saith Yah of hosts, the children of Israel and the children of Yahuda were oppressed together, and all that took them captives held them fast. They refused to let them go. Okay? And because I I ended Micah 7:15, you know, like according to the coming out of Egypt, right? Next to that. Verse 34. Their Redeemer is strong. Yah of hosts is his name. He shall fairly plead their cause, that he may give rest to the land and disquiet the inhabitants of Babylon. And rest to the land, is Israel, right? And quiet the inhabitants of Babylon, that's the door to Babylon here that we in, right? Right now. A sword is upon the Chaldeans, saith Yah, and upon the inhabitants of Babylon, and upon her princes, and upon her wise men. This is this, daughter of Babylon. All right? A sword is upon the liars, and they shall dote. If you're a liar, you're going to be weak-minded. Huh? A sword is upon her mighty men, and they shall be dismayed. Right? That's the armies, right? Navy, Air Force, Marines, right? Army, whatnot, right? A sword is upon their horses and upon their chariots, huh? That's, you know, all the recalls on the chariots, whether they're in the air, the MAX 737, or whether they're on the ground, all these different cars and trucks getting recalls, right? Been talking about that for years, right? Upon all the mingled people that are in the midst of her, right? Again, you in idolatry, the sword is upon you too, right? And they shall become as women. And we see this with the transgenders and the intersex, you know, being changed without, you know, your consent when you first come into the world. You understand? Or you're a transgender when you change on your own will. You follow what I'm saying? Whether you be turning a woman to the man or the man to the woman. You know what I mean? Oh, you understand? Crazy, right? And they shall become as women. A sword is upon her treasures, and they shall be robbed. See, and that's when the money started being robbed back then when they brought in the Federal Reserve. And when they did the, you know, the big collapse back in 29 and 30. And like I said, when they called for the bank holiday in 33, they shut the banks down. That was the bail-in. If you had any money in the bank, it was gone. When the bank opened back up, your money was gone. That's what I just said earlier when I told the brother. He's like, I better go get my butt. See, because now you can't get but $2,000 in a day. Remember I said last year when I was doing work on the building here and I had, you know, to get the money for the workers. I went to the bank, right, and wanted $4,000. And I told you what the sister told me. She said, you got to sign this paper if you want $4,000. I said, what? She said, she showed it to me. They want to know, you know, you got to sign this and you got to tell them what you want the money for. Okay? Right? I said, okay, what did I put on there? Bills. B-I-L-L-S. And an exclamation mark behind it. Bills. You understand what I'm saying? Right? And I had to do that a couple times because we had work done up in here, on the, you know, outside and whatnot on the building, right? So, you know, okay, now, right, with this partial shutdown, you follow what I'm saying? You can only get $2,000 a day. I guess it's a day. That's what it, that's, you know, $2,000 once a day. That's it. See? Now, so you know, like I told my man, you're just a step away for them doing a bail-in. And whatever monies you got up in there, open back up, it's gone. And that's what they did in 33. Now, when you listen to this interview with Alasdair MacLeod on Max Kaiser, he gonna talk about that. He gonna touch on that. You follow me? But he tell you, he said, but America was in a different situation back in 33. He said, cause when the stocks collapsed and whatnot, and the recession, depression began in 29, he said they was able to make it 3.5 years cause the dollar was backed by gold. Okay? In other words, they had a cushion then. He said, that doesn't exist today. Dollar not backed by anything, as I've said in the past, but the guns and a promise. And these nations is rising up against America, as I'm just reading you constantly about Iraq, bombing, hitting American military bases. Get out of here, right? And you got plenty of countries want America out. Abundant on many waters. Right? 800 something military bases. And it could very well be these military bases, they done shipped whatever is the trigger. Listen to me well. Whatever is the trigger to whatever they've been spraying on us, the whole world with these chemtrails, whatever is to trigger this, you understand, SARS-2, this coronavirus, they could have shipped it to all the military bases, and at the given time, they open it up or let out or do whatever they do to start activating this thing. See? You follow me? To start this pandemic. Okay? Now, and again, check this out. You follow what I'm saying? You understand? Other Illuminati members that's running China, that's running Russia, and so on and so forth. You follow what I'm saying? They know, they can very well know about this, but they can't tell the people in actuality. Right? Now, China's come out and said this. They believe it's America doing it. Then America come back, oh, it's China. Right? But they can't just come out, because then they'll reveal the whole plan that they've been in on from 81. Eyes of Darkness. You get my drill? You follow what I'm saying? So they can't just tell everything, because they implicate themselves. You follow me? See? But again, y'all's telling us right here, the treasures of the daughter of Babylon going to be robbed. They've been robbing our money ever since 33. Really before that, because they came up with the income tax plan in 1916. They started, you know, applying that. You follow what I'm saying? So they've been robbing, you understand, robbing the people of their money ever since, you know, what, over 100 years, over a century. Right? See, so now I'm back here reading this article. Now check it out again. The Fed, Federal Reserve, right? 9 central banks, start currency swap plan, right? Okay. Now, again, sometimes, you know, these foreign banks provide dollars to their banks that sometimes lend and trade in U.S. currency. Now check this out. Okay. It is the latest effort by the Fed to smooth the functioning of financial markets as investors, banks, and companies rush to stockpile cash amid plunging stock markets and a sharply slowing economy. Late Wednesday, the Fed also reactivated its third lending facility dating from the financial crisis, intended to provide more cash to banks in the form of short-term loans. The currency swaps established Thursday are capped at $60 billion for central banks in Australia, Brazil, Mexico, Singapore, Korea, and Sweden. Okay? The exchange lines are capped at $30 billion for central banks in Denmark, Norway, and New Zealand. All right? Okay? So you don't see Britain in there at all. You don't see France or Germany in there at all, right? You understand? Now, Denmark, Norway, and New Zealand told them, we ain't taking $60 billion of that junk. We'll take 30, that's it. Okay? We'll take 30. We ain't taking 60. That's too much. And we give you $30 billion of our money. Now, why is it that the Fed wants this other money? In my mind, right? Because they know they can't do anything with it in certain areas of the world, certain situations. The people ain't taking the dollar. So they'll take the New Zealand money or the Australia money, huh? Or the Brazil money or the Mexico money or the Singapore money or the Korea money or the Sweden money, the Denmark money, the Norway money. They'll take that. You understand? But they don't want that dollar. I mean, that's the only reason I can see, right? Now, check it out. The Fed already maintains such currency exchanges with 5 other central banks. Okay, here we go. Including the European Central Bank, the Bank of Japan, and the Bank of Canada. See, because they all control by the, you know, the same people. You know, you understand? The Illuminati at the top, right? Late Wednesday, the Fed announced its third emergency lending program to provide money to banks that purchase financial assets from money market mutual funds. Huh? Oh, man. Including short-term IOUs known as commercial paper. By facilitating the purchase of commercial paper, which is issued by large businesses and banks, the Fed hopes to spur more lending to firms seeking to raise cash as their revenues plummet amid the spread of the coronavirus. Gonna blame everything on that, right? Not that the dollar is worth it and these plenty of nations don't want it. It's the coronavirus, right? This facility, known as the Money Market Mutual Fund Liquidity Facility, you hear that? The Money Market Mutual Fund Liquidity Facility is intended to help money market funds unload assets such as commercial paper, but also treasury securities and bonds guaranteed by mortgage giants Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac. Okay? Tell you. You're going to hear Alasdair MacLeod allude to that. Okay? Tell you, the game is on. All right? Chicago Sun-Times, March the 22nd. Senator Soul stopped before steep Wall Street losses. I mentioned that earlier, right? And this Senator Richard Byrd, Republican out of North Carolina, and his wife sold stock in more than 30 transactions from late January to mid-February because they got the inside scoop. And so they trying to sell out, you understand, and get the cash before this thing collapse, right? Just like Joe Kennedy did back there before the big crash back there in 29. We talked about that. That's public knowledge, right? And many others, right? Okay, I tell you, boy, the game is on. But again, y'all bringing all this out, huh, into the public eye, huh? Now, okay, because they, you know, it's another senator out of North Carolina. He tweeted that Burr owes the public an explanation. North Carolinians an explanation. Okay? I tell you, boy, this thing is something else. Now, say, Burr was not the only lawmaker to sell off stocks just before the steep decline spurred by world pandemic. Georgia Senator Kelly Loeffler, a new senator who is up for re-election this year, sold off hundreds of thousands of dollars worth of stock in late January as senators began to get briefings on the virus, also according to Senate records. Now, these are Republicans, huh? These are Republicans. This Burr is a Republican. It doesn't say what this Loeffler is. Now, this is the woman whose husband is, now check it out, now I'm gonna read it to you, right? The Daily Beast first reported that Loeffler dropped the stock in late January. The senator is married to Jeffrey Sprecher, Sprecher, the chairman and CEO of Intercontinental Exchange, which owns the New York Stock Exchange. Now, you going to tell me she didn't know what time it was? Huh? In a tweet early Friday, Loeffler said the report was a ridiculous and baseless attack. Okay? Investment decisions are made by multiple third-party advisors without my or my husband's knowledge or involvement. Yeah, right. And I got a bridge I can sell you too if you believe that. Okay? Over in the Wuhan province. I got a bridge to sell you if you believe that. Right? She says she was informed of the decisions 3 weeks after they were made. You understand what I mean? So the deal is, she got the inside information about the buy. She told her husband, who works as chairman of the CEO of the company that owns the New York Stock Exchange, and then he did the transaction. You follow what I'm saying? Nah. Okay. Senator Dianne Feinstein, Democrat out of California, also reported that her husband sold off between $1.1 million and $5.5 million worth of stock. Okay. All the gene therapeutics more than a month ago. The San Francisco-based biotech company researches and develops cures for cancer. Okay, because they know all that stock gonna drop. You follow me? So they got out. Boy, Feinstein, who also sits on the intelligence panel, you hear that? Intelligence panel, said in a statement that she didn't attend the January 24 briefing and had no input into her husband's decision. Yeah, right. Okay. No, because she probably already She didn't have to attend the meeting. She was too busy trying to run and dump that stock. You guys know what I mean? She already knew about it. Okay. So this company is unrelated to any work on the coronavirus, and the sale was unrelated to the situation. Yeah, right. Okay. Oklahoma Senator James Inhofe also sold off anywhere between roughly $395,000 and $850,000 worth of stock he held in multiple companies in late January, early February. Yeah, it's all coincidence, right? You believe that? You follow what I'm saying? And again, for those of you out there, it's this guy called Greg Mannarino. Okay, Gregory Mannarino, you can go on the internet, look him up, look and see what he say. You follow what I'm saying? Because again, he tell you he a Mason, but he in that stock game. He been into it. He been making calls, right? Right calls. And listen to what he say all about this. He tell you it's all planned. All right? You understand? Go to Greg Mannarino, okay? And Yadina, she hip to him. We was talking, and she said, he a Mason. I said, yeah, I heard him say it. You know, she said, yeah. She said, you know, he bring up about that Genesis 3:22. So I said, yeah, I heard him say that too. She said, yeah. She said, you know, what do you think about that? She said, because I don't think he got that right. I said, well, think about it. I said, go there and check it out. What does it say? You know, because in Genesis 3:22, you know, the man that beguiled Eve is telling Eve, you know, you can do this. In other words, you can go on and have sex with me. Do what you want to do. You understand? Well, that's what it was all about. It wasn't about no apple. You understand what I'm saying? And again, he's saying, you know, Yah knows that if you eat of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, you'll be like him. That's what 3:22 Genesis says, right? Okay. So now I said to Yadina, I said, but you know, she went there. I said, read it. She read it. So then, you know, I said, what did that make you think about? I said, think about, you know, Skull and Bone 3:22. And she said, yeah. I said, you know, 3:22 is like Yosha said to me here a few years ago. I said that to all of you, right? He said, it could very well be this was the year, not 320 BC, but 3:22. You know, when that book, America's Secret Establishment, Skull and Bones 3:22. And this is when, you know, the year after, they had murdered, poisoned Alexander, right? 322 BC. I said, yeah, you very well, I can see that. You're probably right. That's why they say Skull and Bone 322, you know what I mean? America's Secret Establishment, right? Okay. But again, it goes back to the point that these handful of illuminated Edomites, right? They weren't totally illuminated, but in their mind at that time, they probably thought they were totally illuminated. Why? Because they looked at the book of Daniel as not being authentic. They didn't give it any relevance. They like, Daniel ain't no prophet. You understand? He wasn't standing in his light yet. Daniel 12, verse 13. You understand? Which goes over there basically with, you understand, chapter 8. He wasn't standing in his light yet. You follow what I'm saying? See, he wasn't looked at as a prophet. You follow me? Okay, in regards to, again, Daniel 12, verse 11, concerning the daily sacrifice, right? And again, it wasn't until after the end of them days, you follow what I'm saying, of the daily sacrifice, right? The 2,300 24-hour days, right? That ended, you know, April, what we call April 14, 161 BCE, right? It's sometime after that, when the handful of Amalekite Edomites who descended from those handful of Amalekite Edomites that was back up there in 322, you know, that more than likely, you know, came up with the plan, you understand, to get rid of Alexander and fan the flames to divide Ptolemy from Alexander. You follow what I'm saying? And probably came up with the plan to, you know, poison Alexander systematically because he was broken, as the prophecy so stated, right? You understand? With hand. You follow me? Adverse to the little horn, Antioch's Epiphanes in chapter 8, Daniel was broken without hand because he died of an epileptic fit, right? Okay, so now, you follow what I'm saying? That's when they looked at, they had become like Yah, huh? To know good and evil, to know what was going to happen in the future. Well, they got the book, and like I said, they're not looking at Daniel as a prophet at all. So they figured they had it all of what Yah said was going to happen. You follow what I'm saying? That's why they, you understand, the 83rd Psalm, right? They was like, let's keep them cut off forever. You follow me? Because we can see Yah, they done cut themselves off from Yah, the tree of life. Now they going into abject darkness, right? So we got to keep them cut off forever. See? So we going to feed them by all which came out in the form of Jesus. Huh? We're going to feed them the Egyptian, huh, worship of the S-U-N, but we're going to tell it, you know, put it in the guise of Jesus. You understand? We're going to feed them this everlasting life. You know, you're going to be resurrected after you literally die and go into the hole in the ground of the sepulchre, right? Jesus is going to raise you back up. We're going to feed them that, which was, the old Egyptian religion. That was one of the main things that got us, you know, our forefathers, the children of Israel, turned out in Egypt. You know, that's Ezekiel chapter 23, right? See, so Esau put all that together. Let's keep them cut off, which is, again, you see at the top of 83rd Psalm. Let's deal craftily with them. Let's repackage the things that got themselves cut off from Yah. We're going to repackage it, put it in a, you understand, another label on it, call it new, right? You understand? And package it and put it behind the book of remembrance, right? Malachi 3:15 to 18 verse. And we're going to put a wrap around it and call it the Holy Bible. But it's the New Testament of our Lord, Yahushua the Anointed, or Jesus the Christ. See? Okay, you follow me? And we keep them cut off forever. See, so again, when they, you understand, got the book, they, like I say, Daniel was the last book per se that they got their hands on, because that was with Nehemiah when he came back from Persia. You know, like I say, four twenty-three BCE. When he came back, he got that book of Daniel with him. See, they understood it. You know, our few forefathers that were still in around your room, they understood it, right? Which is intimated again in Daniel chapter 11, verse what, 32:3? But those who do know Yah, in other words, but those who do know the word of Yah and knew what Daniel had prophesied about this time, they, it was only a few that understood it. They knew what was jumping off. So they instructed many. But many of them who was even, you know, trying to be upright fail at that time. You understand? When Antioch Epiphanes was killing Hebrews, Edomites, and Israelites, the mighty and the holy people. Daniel chapter 8. You follow me? See? So to them, Daniel wasn't a prophet. He wasn't standing in his light. So they think they knew it all. But even with, you know, even with what they had that they, you understand, you still don't really understand, you know, Yeshaya, Yeremiah, huh, Ezekiel without the book of Daniel. You still don't really understand that. Not to its depth, you don't. Not without the book of Daniel. Okay? Follow me? So again, they were, you know, 322. BCE, huh? They thought they were like Yah in 322 BCE, huh? Oh, we got the word of Yah. We got the plan, huh? We like Yah now to know good and evil. We didn't know what's going to happen before it happened. See? So, that might be why this Gregory Manarino, you know, it's there, Genesis 322, huh? Suntime, March 21st, right? Pandemic shows how Trump got away with so many scams. See? And this big article, you know, he said, as was only fitting on St. Patrick's Day, my brother Tommy and I congratulated each other on our hardy Irish peasant genes. Centuries of living on dirt floors with pigs, we smugly agreed, have rendered us mixed immune from contagion. This is this Gene Lyons. He, you know, you understand, he Irish, okay? And he writes this little scenario, okay? But then when he gets down here, he said, but no, Tommy and I are hardly immune, nor is anybody else we love. Meanwhile, we also agreed that if anything good can possibly come out of the COVID-19 pandemic, it could only be the decline and fall of Boss Trump, the world's biggest and most incompetent bluffer. See, I skipped a little bit to get to that. You know what I mean? But you can see basically from what I read right there, you know, he's the biggest, as he say, and most incompetent bluffer. You know, because again, he shows how Trump looks when this Fauci, which I know he's an Edomite, that Dr. Fauci, right? Trump say one thing, Fauci get up there and say the opposite. You know Trump didn't like it, right? And it got to a point where Trump, he would get a press conference, he wouldn't have Fauci there. Okay? See what I'm saying? Okay. Chicago Tribune, right? March 21st. New York orders all residents to stay home. California, Illinois also issue orders to fight virus spread. Okay. North Carolina senator asked for ethics review of his stock sales. Okay. That's that Burr. Right? Senator Intelligence Committee Chairman, and he's the Senate Intelligence Committee Chairman, Richard Burr, right? Republican out of North Carolina, is asking for an ethics review after coming under criticism for selling off as much as $1.7 million in stocks just before the market dropped in February amid coronavirus fears, right? Because, you know, ain't nothing going to come up. They ain't going to do nothing to him. Because he the chairman. He the chairman of the investigative committee now. You know, the fox inspecting the hen house, right? You know, the chicken coop, right? Just like they put Joe Kennedy over the SEC in 35 after the crash and whatnot. They put the fox over the hen house, Joe Kennedy. He's the chairman of the SEC Stock Exchange Commission, right? Okay. March 21st, Chicago Sun-Times, the coronavirus is shutting the economy down. Dow drops more than 900 points, ending worst week since 2008. So they've kind of brought it back a little bit, right? So, you know, as of yesterday, I don't know what it's doing today, right? But it's not finished. Like I said, you go to that Greg Mannarino, listen to what he said, all right? Because he got a few things up. Greg Mannarino. All right. March 22nd, Chicago Sun-Times, 401s not so okay. You hear that? That's the 401k. And if they not so okay, the 457Bs, 403Bs, and all the rest of these stocks, these plans is not okay. Pension plans, right? From all-time highs to devastating Wall Street plunge in weeks. Experts say recession ahead. There you go. Okay. Told you they wasn't gonna let these people keep that money. They gonna, and it's not over with. See? And they got them locked in. You can believe they can't just come get that money. You know what they gonna tell them? If you want that money, you gotta quit your job. Now, how many people gonna do that? You understand? Because if you don't have that kind of faith in y'all, you're not doing that. Like the brother I told y'all about some years back. Huh? He put his faith in Yah. He all right now. He got his money out, right? He got silver and whatnot. He stocked up, got silver, him and his wife. You follow what I'm saying? And he done had three jobs since then. Okay? He got a good job right now. Now, you understand what I'm saying? The mood and everything, right? See? He got his faith in Yah. They've got their faith in Yah. See? Yeah, but these people out here today, they in idols, huh? Mad upon their idols, huh? See, so Esau know how to stop them at the from the rush. Well, we get to you, but you know it's gonna take a while. But you know you're gonna have to quit your job. Yeah, you know you're gonna get with that. I don't want to do that. It'll be all right. You know they're gonna tell them it'll be all right. See, it'll come back. Yeah, right. You follow me? Chicago Sun-Times, March 22nd. Terrifying tolls go up. Nearly 800 new deaths in Italy. 10,000 cases in New York, and they scramble for beds and supplies. Okay. Deal on $1 trillion plus rescue plan close. Close. Right? They still hadn't done it yet, right? 38 positive for virus in New York City jails. So they let some of these people out these jails that's not violent criminals, right? But they let them out. They, you know, they don't want to keep them up in there anyway. They get tired of feeding them and housing them. That's money. You know what I mean? Chicago Tribune, March 22nd. Economic rescue package tops $1 trillion amid talks. See, they saying $1 trillion. But again, they hid that $4 trillion extra over the $2.2 trillion because it's over $6 trillion. And like I said, I've heard it could go to $8 trillion. All right? That's what that Matt stole on Democracy Now. He was, boy, he was raising Cain that morning. You go and watch that if you didn't see it. He's running it down. March 22nd, Chicago Tribune. Netanyahu proposes stepping down in power sharing deal. Okay. See? Say the Edomites is facing a growing threat from the coronavirus pandemic. It has detected nearly 900 cases and on Friday reported its first death. See? Because it's over in the land too. So who you know, who's talking about they left out of America already, went to the land because 4820 Yeshaya. You know, because the coronavirus is here in America. It's over there, too. All right? Say, Blue and White has accused Netanyahu, that's Benny Gantz's party, right, of using the coronavirus crisis to undermine the country's democratic institutions and try to derail his scheduled trial on corruption charges. Senior members of Gantz's party have expressed skepticism at previous power-sharing overtures by Netanyahu, concerned that he would not follow through on his promises. Well, they can just about depend on that. All right. I tell you, boy, strong earthquake in Greece. An earthquake with a preliminary magnitude of 5.6 struck northwestern Greece early Saturday, causing damage to buildings but no reported injuries. Okay. They had a torrential rainfall in Indiana. 6 people died as of this writing. Okay? Because, you know, they got torrential rainfalls around here in the country. Storms and whatnot. Okay? Chicago Tribune, March 23rd. Palestinian Health Ministry. Gaza confirms first virus cases. So it's in the land. Right? Strongest quake in 140 years strikes near Croatia's capital. Now, this is in Croatia. They had a big strong earthquake. Okay, 5.3. Okay. Also, New York area airport workers laid off. Marriott to start furloughs. A lot of people losing jobs behind this coronavirus. Okay. And say conservationists warn of the virus risk to gorillas. So now if the gorillas can get it, can't dogs and cats get it? But that couple I told you about, they brought the dog in the shower with them. They washed themselves with the dog. Also, first federal jail inmate test positive for virus. Okay? This is in New York City. So they let different prisoners out of New York City jail, just like they let out here in Chicago. Chicago Tribune, March 23rd. The Fed, Federal Reserve, hustles to restore order to economy. Yeah, right. Okay. And again, it says the Fed made a rate cut of 0.5 percentage point on March 3rd and then on March 15th announced additional emergency actions to try to lessen the economic impact of the coronavirus outbreak. Okay? Because they talk about in here, the Fed slashed its benchmark interest rate to near zero. It will buy at least $500 billion in Treasury securities and $200 billion in mortgage-backed securities over the coming months to help unclog. See, it's like a backed-up toilet, right? Unclog the world financial markets, known as quantitative easing, printing paper, right? And it will work with other central banks, the Bank of Canada, I just mentioned them, right? The Bank of England, now I didn't mention that one, but that's here now. The Bank of Japan, the European Central Bank, and the Swiss National Bank to help world-funded markets in an attempt to encourage all the central banks to use dollars to help their own financial system. Yeah, to help them. Really, it's to help this, keeping the dollar in play, right? You know, switcheroo. The Fed also announced a series of steps to boost bank lending by dropping the rate charged to banks for short-term emergency loans from its discount window from 1.75 to 0.25, and it wants banks to tap their reserves to lend to households and businesses affected by the coronavirus. And what they say, they not lending anything to the people, huh? Chicago Sun-Times, March the 24th, suddenly out of work. Here's how to apply for unemployment benefits amid state shutdown. See, and this is one of your beauty houses, you okay? Because that came past some of these beauty salons, all shut down, right? All shut down. But like I said, Nancy Pelosi, she don't look like she missed her hair, you know, her hair appointment, right? Trump and all them up there at Capitol Hill, the White House, right? They getting their nails done and whatnot. So they're around somebody because I know they're not doing it. You follow what I'm saying? Chicago Tribune, March 24th. Fed makes strongest bid yet to shield economy. You hear that? To shield economy. Central bank to buy treasuries to support credit markets. Printing paper. That's all it is, huh? Printing paper. Food supply system faces strain. Logistics of transporting goods from point A to point B forms complicated web because they say these truckers, you know, they got to move this stuff. So now with the shutdown, the truckers, you understand what I'm saying? See? Germany okays $1.1 trillion to keep businesses afloat. All right? It's worldwide. Just like it was in 29, 30, 31, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It was the war, World War II, that brought the world out of depression. Okay? Not the New Deal. Chicago Tribune, March the 25th. COVID-19 as boomer remover. Let's talk about that. Now, this article show you this old person walking, right? And you see what she's saying? Boomer remover, right? As all in the baby boom, which is from what, 46 to like, 57? I think that's, they call that the baby boomer period. 46 to 57, so it's about what, 12 years, something like that? That's the baby boom period. And those are the ones getting pensions, Social Security. And so she said, baby boomer remover. Because she heard about, you know, Trump said, you know, we got to get the economy back and running. Older folks got to go to work. And if they die, you know, they got to make the economy better for their children, for their grandchildren, right? And then the lieutenant governor down there in Texas, he bagged Trump in that, right? He said, you know, if I had to give myself up for my children, I do that. I'm not a hero, but I give myself up, right? Because they want to get rid of the people on Social Security. Huh? The people that got these pension plans, the baby boomers, and they say that this, you know, COVID-19, right, or SARS-2 is definitely more detrimental to the people that's, what, 60 years and older, right? Chicago Tribune, March 25th, huh? Arizona man's death spurs warning against self-medication. Huh? Because Trump came out and told people, you understand, you can take the malaria drug for this COVID-19. And Dr. Fossey told him, no, that ain't gonna work. Some people did that. And this man died. Okay? You say Trump kept saying it was basically pretty much a cure. The woman, this man's wife, told NBC, right? Okay? It says, a Phoenix area man has died and his wife was in critical condition after the couple took chloroquine phosphate, an additive used to clean fish tanks that is also found in an anti-malaria medication that's been touted by President Donald Trump as a treatment for COVID-19. That's how people listen to Trump. They went, took this chloroquine phosphate, right? It's used to clean fish tanks. And the man died, she in critical condition. And she told NBC, well, Trump said it was okay. Okay? Nah. Okay, I tell you, boy. Woo! Huh? Idolaters, right? You know that's what they are. Huh? Because nobody who's totally plugged into Yah with all their heart and soul gonna listen to Trump about too much of anything. You follow what I'm saying? Like I said, you listen to him, whatever he say is the opposite. Okay? Chicago Tribune, March 25th. China eases lockdown in show of confidence. Okay? Virus rekindles 2010 oil spill memories along Gulf Coast. Right? Virus rekindles 2010 oil spill memories along Gulf Coast. Okay? Because again, it's got everything in disarray. Like the, you know, when the oil spill in 2010 had everything in disarray, right? Also, Likud members urge Speaker to defy Israeli high court order. Okay? So they the different Likud members is urging Netanyahu to defy the court order, right? You understand? We don't have to listen to no court order, right? Also, in Libya, the national oil company said economic fallout from a protracted blockade of its vital oil facilities has resulted in losses surpassing $3.5 billion at a time when the war-torn country is struggling to prevent COVID-19. Okay? So, they got a block. Huh? Blockade. And who's blocking it? Because they don't really say in this article who's actually blocking it. Okay, say powerful tribes lured the Libya's eastern base forces, seized large export terminals, and choked off major pipelines in January. Okay, aiming to starve the Tripoli-based government of revenue, crucial revenue. All right, so again, Tripoli's been a mess ever since, huh? The Illuminated Edomite and Skull and Bone Boys knocked off Gaddafi. All right. And I wonder who's backing the eastern faction of Libyan, you know, got them where they got the blockade on the other ones. I wonder who's backing the ones who's creating the blockade. You follow me? Chicago Tribune, March 25th. Distilleries going all in. Producers of spirits hoping to find a new revenue stream in hand sanitizer. But they like, we got to put out as much hand sanitizer as we can to take advantage of this market while it's hot, right? So we can make all the money we can make, huh? You follow me? That's what's going on, okay? Because when this thing is over, we might be out of work. So we got to make as much money as we can off hand sanitizer. So they distilleries supposed to be making booze, but they're like, we're going to make hand sanitizer. Forget about the booze, okay? We got to strike the iron while the iron is hot, right? So they're making hand sanitizers instead of Cutty Sark and, you know what I'm saying? Instead of, you know, these different alcohol beverages that they make, scotch and, you understand? And, you know, what's the other, bourbon and whatnot. We're going to make hand sanitizer, okay? Chicago Tribune, March 25th. Airlines cut thousands of U.S. flights amid virus. Okay? Shut down. Okay? Okay, the Federal Reserve scammers prey on Medicare recipients. Huh? See? You got vultures out here trying to take advantage of the situation. So you got to be careful because the vultures is out here. Chicago Sun-Times, March 26th. First back-to-back gain since sell-off began, but stocks fade. Huh? They had some back-to-back gain, then they faded again. That's what they're going to do for a while, right? It's still going down. Boeing could get up to $17 billion in loans in Congress deal. You know, I heard they got more. They're getting more than that. Okay? But again, you know, total mismanagement, and then they're going to get a bailout. Billions of dollars, right? Bailout might boost public transit, but more help will be needed soon, right? Because again, people not going to work, people not riding public transit, so public transportation, you know, the public trans, they need input of cash, right? Shutdown, major, you know, collapse all over, right? That's depression, right? Chicago Sun-Tab, March 26th. It's unanimous. Senate approves $2.2 trillion coronavirus package. But in actuality, it's over $6 trillion. Like $6.2 trillion. They don't tell about the other $4 trillion in this. All right? Okay. Disaster grips New York. State has nearly 300 deaths as total U.S. fatalities top 1,000. Chicago Sun-Times, March 26th. Pompeo wants diplomats to use term Wuhan virus. Huh? Want to blame it on the Chinese. So he chastised some of these diplomats when they had this meeting from, you know, other diplomats from other countries, and they wasn't going for it. You know, they wasn't saying that. They was calling it coronavirus. He like, you should say Wuhan. He's like, we ain't going for that. You understand what I'm saying? Tell you, boy. Now, so who's the real, where is this virus really emanating from? Chicago Sun-Times, March the 26th, right? Consumers' credit also needs protection from virus, this group says, okay? They said amid the wrangling in Congress over what to do to halt the spread of the coronavirus and assist struggling businesses, a coalition of consumer groups wants to make sure ordinary people don't see their credit destroyed by the financial upheaval, because that's what happened in 2008. And you got people still haven't recovered from that. Okay? Chicago Tribune, March 26th, huh? Asian Americans made to feel as if we are the virus. Okay, look at her. She's you know, because of what Trump is talking about, call it the China virus. So Asian Americans getting attacked. Chicago Tribune. March 26th, Trump suicide warning, misguided and wrong. You know, in other words, you know, baby boomer, you know, go on out there and go to work. And if you die, so what? You know what I mean? You got to help the economy for your grandchildren, your children, your great-grandchildren. You know what I mean? See, and that's what this article, Trump suicide warning, misguided and wrong, right? Tell you, boy. Loss of smell, taste might signal virus, right? Loss of taste and smell might signal virus. Chicago Tribune, March the 26th, Trump's Easter goal and appeal to faith, business. And really, you should put the business first, okay? You about making money. You follow me? Advisors say Target offers hope. Health experts alarmed. Now they done changed because there ain't no way this thing gonna be straightened out by no, you understand, middle of April. You can forget that, all right? And again, down here at the bottom, Prince Charles infected with coronavirus, officials said. You know, I don't believe that. It could be, but I don't believe it. All right, I think the monarchy, you know, they gonna say you got it and make people feel like we party, you know, we like everybody else. Okay? But he could, but I don't know. You understand? Chicago Tribune, March 26th. Healthcare workers reeling from virus in Spain and Italy. Okay? Because it took off in Spain and Italy. Police use force to enforce India's mandatory lockdown. Because the people over in India, they was coming out, they started beating them with batons, and they got real nasty on them. Real nasty. Firefighters sprayed disinfectants to fight the coronavirus on Wednesday in Guwahati, India. Okay? It almost looks like fire, don't it? Huh? Almost looks like fire they spraying, but does some kind of disinfectant, so they say. Right? You know, because Trump was just over there dealing with that Modi, seeing him, right, over there in India. Narendra Modi, prime minister, right? Also, Netanyahu ally quits as Israeli political chaos ratchets up, huh? The Israeli parliament speaker resigned Wednesday, dealing a blow to Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu and deepening the country's political turmoil as the embattled Israeli leader tries to cling to power amid a fast-spreading outbreak of the coronavirus and a looming corruption trial. Okay, you reap what you sow, right? The illuminated Edomite and Edomites then dividing everybody else. Now y'all, putting diversity amongst them. Chicago Tribune, March 26th. Ford recalls 268,000 cars to fix latches. Huh? Sword on the chariots. Over there in Jeremiah chapter 50. Huh? Chicago Sun-Times, March 27th. Cash up to $1,200 for individuals to hit direct deposit under legislation. You know, but when is it coming? Because the people needed it yesterday. All right? $1,200. And like Yada said, that should be $1,200 a week. You know, $1,200 a week. What do they say over here? $1,200 a month, right? They say the checks are coming one-time payments. You hear that? One-time payments of up to $1,200 should start going out in the next 3 weeks. So that's 3 weeks from March 27th. So that's like the middle, huh? The middle toward the, going toward the third week in April. That's when the checks should be direct deposited, right? And those who file joint returns will get up to $2,400, right? Says, going out next week to most Americans who file individual tax returns. All right? So that's a one-time payment. Man. Like y'all said, they should get that $1,200 a week until this thing is over with. But that'd be too much like doing what's right, huh? Chicago Sun-Times, March 27th. Stocks roar again despite jobless claims. And you know this is all manipulation. You know, like this guy said, I can never say his name. Yadida knows how his name is. He's Robert. He's Asian. He's up in there. He's one of these economists, right? He's writing a book with James Ricketts called The Raven. And I was watching him, Shirasaki, I think his name is. Shirasaki, Robert Shirasaki. And he was like, you know, that stock is all manipulated. He said, I go up 1,000 one day and go down 1,200 the next and go back 800. He said, it's all manipulation. So he was laughing about it, you know. If you pull up that Greg Mannarino on your internet over to the side, you'll probably see that Robert Shirasaki. I think that's how you say his name. Go to him and check him out what he said, because he was laughing. He was talking about, he said, I've been talking about this for years. People been laughing at me. So he was laughing when he was talking about it. He like, they've been laughing and mocking me all these years. He said, I was 4 or 5 years old. He said, but here it is. Okay. Because he was talking about, he said, I got thousands of ounces of silver. He said, I got gold. He said, and I got ammunition. He said, I'm an ex-Marine. Okay, I tell you, he's running it down, all right? He wasn't even, you know, sparing any of these people who've been mocking him all these years, okay? U.S. indicts Venezuela's Maduro. I know plenty of you probably heard about that. Some more nonsense, right? They're going to indict Maduro as a drug trafficker, him and some of his administration. Now, who trafficked more drugs than America, huh? Weren't the Sackler family, the Edomite Sackler family here in America putting all that Oxycontin out for how long? 30, 40 years? About 30 years or better? Huh? And they became multi-billionaires? Now that's just them. That's not talking about Barry Seal in the gang. Huh? You follow me with all the cocaine? Right? You follow what I'm saying? Who's bringing all this cocaine and marijuana and heroin into this country? Because we didn't have no ships and no planes back there in the 60s, huh? In the 50s, in the 60s, in the 70s, in the 80s, you know what I'm saying? Who's bringing all the drugs in? Danilo Blandone, who was with, Freeway Ricky Ross. That was Freeway Ricky Ross's connection. Danilo Blandone, CIA guy. So who bring in more drugs than America? Now they gonna talk about Maduro is a drug trafficker. You know what I'm saying? I tell you, boy, they done ran out of stuff about Maduro, haven't they? Huh? Chicago Sun-Tan, March 27, China and America's coronavirus lies. Now this is the article I was telling you about. This, her name is Mona Karin. She did a detailed date analogy of the things that were said by this Trump and Xi Jinping, or whatever, how you pronounce his name. So, you understand? Said this is a tale of two governments. Both were faced with a potential disaster, a new and deadly epidemic. Both made choices that the world will judge. Okay, this is China. The virus made its first appearance in Wuhan Wet Market, an emporium apparently common in China that featured live and newly slaughtered animals in close proximity. SARS and avian flu are also thought to have originated in these markets, which amount to an ongoing threat to world health. See, thought to, at least that's the spin she gonna put down. From the first reported case on December 1st, 2019, huh? Now again, the first case, December 1st, 2019, but the assimilated, hypothetical analogy and that event 201 conference in New York was October 2019, right? Say from the first reported case on December 1st, 2019 until January 5th, 2020, the Chinese government engaged in a cover-up. That's what she said, right? As National Review's Jim Garrity recounted in early January, China's National Health Commission forbade reporting on the new disease. On December 30th, Dr. Ling Wanglin sent a message to other physicians warning that a SARS-like illness was spreading. Okay, but like I say, they had the conference in October 2019 in New York. And now it pops up in China in December 2019. Now she's writing it from the aspect of it's the Chinese, right? So, it says throughout early January, as cases mounted, the Chinese government issued soothing statements suggesting that the new pneumonia was not transmitted from person to person. As late as January 15th, after Thailand and Japan had reported their first cases, official government sources were denying that human-to-human transmission had been proven, saying the risk was low. Only on January 23rd, 6 weeks after the first case, did China announce a quarantine of Wuhan. By that time, millions had come and gone from the city during the busy holiday season, and cases had been reported in Vietnam, Singapore, Hong Kong, and South Korea. Now, that's January 23rd, right? U.S. President Donald Trump engaged in a series of soothing statements himself. On January 22nd, after the first U.S. case was reported, he said, "We have it together. We have it totally under control," quote, right? On February 2nd, right, he boasted that we pretty much shut it down coming in from China. Twice in February, the president promised that when we get into April in the warmer weather, that has a very negative effect on that and that type of a virus. On February 26, when cases topped 60, Trump claimed we're going very substantially down, not up. In South Carolina on 28th of February, Trump likened criticism of his handling of the pandemic to impeachment, saying that this is their new hoax. All right. On March 6th, he continued this theme, facing criticism for his false statement that anyone who wants a test can get a test. Trump tried to string together a fake news Ukraine thing. He said the tests were beautiful, adding the tests are all perfect, like the letter was perfect, the transcription was perfect, right? See, he's being sarcastic. Asked, talking about that Mueller stuff and all that stuff, right? Asked whether he was concerned about the virus spread on March 7th, the president said, no, we've done a great job. Throughout the first 10 weeks of the pandemic, Trump praised China effusively as the bulwark's Jim Swift chronicle. On March 7th, for example, Trump said great discipline is taking place in China as President Xi strongly leads what will be a very successful operation. We are working closely with China to help. A few days later, he shared with Fox News his view that China is very, very, you know, professionally run in the sense that they have everything under control. I really believe they're going to have it under control fairly soon. Okay? See, so, you know, it says, when the lies were no longer tenable, President Trump pivoted 2 days after claiming that the disease was under control. Trump declared himself a wartime president and offered that I've always known this is a pandemic. I felt it was a pandemic long before it was called a pandemic. Now, which is it? Can't have it both ways. Okay, that's around the time Larry King, the journalist, you know, a TV radio host, Larry King was being interviewed by Lee Kemp. Larry King said he was embarrassed for Trump. You know, because Trump is totally clueless. Or he just knows so much, like I said earlier. You know, he can't let on that he knew it, right? You understand? So he don't like to be wrong. You know that, because he's a narcissist, right? March 28th. You know, he's ego and prideful driven, right? March 28th, Chicago Sun-Times. Daily briefings prove Trump's uniquely incompetent to handle outbreak. Okay, Trump wasted about 6 weeks assuring himself and his gullible followers that the worst public health crisis in 100 years was a fake news Democratic media hoax. Okay? Now, Chicago Tribune, March 27, human economic toll from virus being felt worldwide. Okay? Don't blame toilet paper for surge in clogs across U.S. Because they say, they got an article here, say this is happening, this is out of New York, right? But this article here says that people been using these paper towels, you know, wiping everything, and they throwing it in the toilet, and there's so many paper towels that's going into the toilet together with toilet paper and feces, whatever, right? It's the clogged up the pipes through the city and other places throughout the country. You follow me? Because you're not supposed to throw paper towels down the toilet. I mean, it might contain one, but not, you know, a mass of them constantly says it's blocking up the pipes and making the pipes burst. So now you got to back up, you understand? From all this, you know, paper towels and whatnot going into the toilets, right? Said many Americans seem to be following the recommendation of public health officials to clean and sterilize countertops, doorknobs, faucets, and other frequently touched surfaces in their homes. However, many are then tossing the disinfectant wipes, which is not even paper towel, right? And paper towels and other paper products they use in the toilet. And the result has been a coast-to-coast surge in backed-up sewer line and overflowing toilets. According to plumbers and public officials who have pleaded with Americans to spare the nation's pipes from further strain. Jeez, man. Chicago Tribune, March 27th, right? Trump camp threatens TV stations over ad, right? commercial uses clips of president downplaying the virus. Okay? So Trump said he understand who put these ads out, they gonna sue him, right? Said President Donald Trump's re-election campaign has threatened legal action against local TV stations in Florida, Michigan, Minnesota, Pennsylvania, and Wisconsin if they don't pull a Democratic anti-Trump commercial that uses clips of the president talking about the coronavirus outbreak. Okay, they use that. Hey, it's his words, right? They upset, right? Okay, also, Netanyahu rivaled to be Israel's new Speaker of Parliament. Okay, so again, him and Benny Gantz came to an agreement. So Benny Gantz is the new Speaker of the Parliament, taking that person's place who left Netanyahu's block. So that's how now they kind of reached some kind of agreement, right? You understand? For the moment. Okay? You know, power sharing is supposed to be, but that ain't going to work out either. Chicago Tribune, March 29th, as world toll keeps rising, world digs in for long haul. Cases top 650,000. U.S. leads countries in reported infections. Okay? And they digging in for the long haul. Like I said, they'll be doing good if this thing is over by June the 1st. Okay? Chicago Tribune. March 29th, and in actuality, they're going to have it go as long as they think they needed to have it go. And it might go most of the year, all right? Okay, safety measures turn violent in Africa, okay? And that was in Kenya, all right? Johannesburg, a crowd of Kenyan ferry commuters as the country's first day of coronavirus curfew slid into chaos, okay? Tell you, boy, it's a mess. A real mess. Chicago Tribune, March 29th. California lawmakers urge public to stay home amid outbreak. Okay? Earthquake shakes Indonesia amid fears over coronavirus. Huh? Earthquake in Indonesia, right? Rosneft hands Venezuela oil business to Russian state firm. Rosneft is the Russian oil firm. All right? And they turned over the Venezuelan oil business because they didn't invest this money in Venezuela, right? They turned it over to the Russian state. You follow what I'm saying? Russian state firm. See? Because, again, this is more than likely why America hasn't invaded Venezuela militarily. Because Russia got a big holdings in there, and so does China. And they done probably told them, hey, you understand? Don't go in militarily because you're messing with our money then. You follow me? So that's why America, you know, standing on the sidelines, huh, on the perimeter, sniping. Now they talk about, you understand, Maduro, a drug dealer, supposed to be sending drugs here to America to try to use that as a weapon against America. Who been dealing more drugs than the CIA? Huh? FBI, you understand, the NSA. Now that's a known fact that the CIA been dealing drugs for years. Now, you follow me? And bringing it all into our community, people of color's community. That's why the Caucasians come in our communities and buy. You understand what I'm saying? Nah, but, you know, they got their own pipeline too. Huh? And then they get, like I said in the past, Caucasian get caught with 50 pounds of cocaine, and they get 2 years probation. You follow me? You know, person of color get caught with 50 bags of crack cocaine, and they get life. You follow me? Yeah, I'm telling you. Inequity, right? Chicago Tribune, March 29th. Researchers, shutdowns may help recovery. Yeah, may. May help. Right? In the meantime, in between time, people starving like Marvin, right? Chicago Sun-Times, March 30th. Tornado strikes in northern Illinois. See? Bad weather, bad for the crops, because this crops this year, I don't know how good they're going to be. I won't see the farmer for about another month and a half, okay? U.S.-led forces pull out a third Iraqi base this month. You hear that? Pull out a third Iraqi base this month, okay? Fassi, right? Anthony Fauci, I know he eat him, right? He looked like he about 4 foot two. He said 200,000 may die. Now, why they say that? Just, you know, why put that out there? You understand? What good is that, right? As U.S. coronavirus cases passes 140,000, Trump extends federal stay at home guidelines. See? See, and again, Chicago Tribune, March the 30th, the farmers, they still getting subsidies rolling in, but it's still not like if they were selling, you know, their crops, making crops and making money, right? Also, water shutoffs in sharp focus amid virus outbreak. Millions across nations simply can't wash their hands. This is out of Detroit, what I mentioned earlier. See, and when you look at one of those Democracy Now! Shows I mentioned, they're going to be talking about this. Okay? And you know mostly it's us, people of color, Israelites, in Detroit. Chicago Tribune, March the 31st. New York governor begs for help amid staggering toll. Okay? Also, this Ayanna Pressley out of Massachusetts, one of the squad, Democratic lawmakers called for racial data in virus tests. They want to see, you know, what's the racial breakdown? Okay? Also, with more infections than China, Spain tightens rules. So they tightening up Spain, but it's really breaking out over there, right? Also, this is what I was telling you earlier. Hundreds attend church, pastor arrested. The Reverend Rodney Howard Brown of the River at Tampa Bay Church speaks Sunday services in Tampa Bay, Florida. I thought it was you, but it's Tampa Bay, Florida. Okay? And he was holding church services, and they arrested him. That's him right there. That's him. See? They arrested him. They like, man, they locked him up. Okay? Chicago Tribune, March 31st. Moscow in lockdown. Rest of Russia next. Okay? Worldwide, right? Worldwide. Inside. Okay. Judge halts lawsuits against local Boy Scout councils. See? Because they didn't file for bankruptcy. So all of these suits coming in, the judge didn't say, hey, cut them off because they bankrupt. Right? See? All these young boys coming out, they adults now, you know, coming out talking about how they were molested, raped, you know, all that pedophilia going on with the Boy Scouts through the years. Okay? Because they named one of these guys, former Scoutmaster Douglas Nail. N-A-I-L. Douglas Nail. All right? Feds revoke reservation status for Massachusetts tribes, 300 acres. Okay? Because I guess these tribes, getting their reservation designation rescinded and removing the land from federal trust. And this representative for the Mashpee Wampanoag tribe said, you know, the move is cruel and unnecessary as the tribe and others across the nation are struggling to respond to the coronavirus pandemic on their sovereign lands. Talk about being blindsided. It was a sucker punch in the face from the bully you thought was your friend, he said Monday. I thought they were calling to see how we're doing in all of this. To do it at 4 p.m. on a Friday during a pandemic, that's sneaky. Okay? Say the U.S. Department of Interior, which oversees Native American affairs, is obligated by a recent federal court decision to remove the special land designations which were bestowed in 2015 under then President Barack Obama, according to Connor Swanson, an agency spokesman. says, in February, the U.S. Court of Appeals in Boston upheld a lower court decision declaring the federal government had not been authorized to take land into trust for the Cape Cod-based tribe. The Mashpee Wampanoag tribe declined to challenge that decision, but Cromwell argues a separate lawsuit filed in federal court in Washington, D.C. is still pending. Okay, so this is, you know, the Trump administration revoking all this stuff. Okay. Tell you, boy. And again, to show you how the Edomite is in an uproar, a pandemic shutdown. Israeli security forces arrest an ultra-Orthodox Jewish man as they close a synagogue Monday in the Mir Shearim neighborhood in Jerusalem amid efforts to curb the spread of COVID-19 pandemic. See, they got him, boy. He's like, I'm going to worship my idol. You understand? That's that Hasidism Judaism, right? And they got him, carried him away, right? You understand? Okay. Chicago Tribune, March 31st. Bailout has a lot of room around the edges. Another bailout. This is way bigger than the one in 2008. Huh? Federal stimulus package built to prevent misuse, so they say. The people out here getting one-time payment of $1,200. But these corporations getting billions of dollars. Billions of dollars. Okay? Say in return for the emergency loans, which could be spun by the Federal Reserve in up to $4.5 trillion. Right? That's on top of the $2.2 trillion. See, pandemic shopping, rations of high demand goods, shoppers in mass, and reminders to keep your distance reflect a brave new world. Okay, got plenty of cash, you can hunker in a bunker. If you got plenty of cash, you can hunker in a bunker. Okay. Say, hand sanitizer, sure. Face mask, fine. But as the coronavirus spread, the rich are investing in a much more extreme way to ward off the disease. Bunkers. Going underground. And you see that talked about over there in Micah chapter 7. But that's, you know, going to happen after the nuclear war that's coming. That's where they're going to be, in them bunkers. But again, the ones that will be here in America, they're going to get wiped out whether they're in a bunker or not. But these other people in other countries got bunkers, that's where they'll be. And you see that talked about in Micah chapter 7, right? After the nuclear war, that's when they're going to come out of their worms like holes. And, you know, they're going to come out of their holes, rather, like holes in the ground like worms after many days. Because they're going to be wanting to wait until the, you know, the radioactivity subsides. That's what that's talking about in Micah 7. Okay, March 31st. Macy's will furlough majority of its workers. You probably heard about that, right? Macy's laying off plenty of people, right? 130,000 employees, including stock people and sales clerks, okay? They'll still collect health benefits, but that's it. It says that is transitioning to an absolute minimum workforce needed to maintain basic operations. Okay, he said Macy's has lost the bulk of its sales due to the temporary closing of all 500 of its stores starting March 18th. The move is perhaps the most dramatic sign that even big name retailers are seeing their businesses evaporate and that the $2 trillion rescue package passed by Congress, and it's, like I say, it's really over $6 trillion as of now, right? Signed by President Donald Trump last week may have come too late for some, not for some, for many. Says more than 190,000 stores, including JCPenney, Neiman Marcus, have temporarily closed, accounting for nearly 50% of the U.S. retail square footage, according to Saunders. Discounter grocers and wholesale clubs that sell essential items like groceries have remained open, though they have their own challenges of keeping up with shoppers who continue to stockpile. Okay? Okay, and China's contagion hotspot reopens. The city in the center, Wuhan, China, okay, virus outbreak was reopening for business Monday after authorities lifted more of the controls that locked down tens of millions of people for 2 months. So it's dissipating in China as of this article here, March 31st, okay, which was yesterday. All right? So the Q&A is to follow. For Yah, righteousness, Jerusalem, and the Holy See. Peace, everybody. Yah bless.